And good morning to you. Welcome to the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Thanks for being with us again on this Thursday. Again, August the what? August the... Oh, stop it already, please. That's old Tiger. He's crying again. Bless his heart. Yes. Yes, I understand, Tiger. Bless your heart. All right, let's see what's going on. Tiger Woods already crying about the PGA. I'm going to make a little change right here. I'm going to tilt this down just a smidgen. How about that? It may be a little bit better. Let's see how that goes. That would be much better. Okay, I'll fix the top. Well, let's do this right here real quick. Hey, this is live as we're doing it here. How about that? Let's tilt this back up. Just a smidgen. And there we go. That'll work. All righty. It's called Live on the Internet. Thanks for being with us, Tom Taylor Sports Show, again on this, yes, on this Thursday. Gosh, where's this week gone? Big thanks yesterday. Again, we were at Bristol Motor Speedway. Had a great time. Thank you again to Drew Bedard. And, oh, gosh, we had our buddy Landon Owen stop by. We also, of course, were joined by our friend and our buddy Gary Mabry, the John City Chamber. Also, Brandon Cross from Bristol Dragway. Tommy Wyman stopped by, of course. And, of course, we had Horace up there with us yesterday as well, the big help. And we appreciate him very, very much. Thanks for being with us here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Again on this Thursday. Let's see if we can change the lighting here just a bit and get rolling here. Whew, on the show. Lots going on today. Got a lot of different folks to talk to. A lot of things happening. Guess we'll start in baseball. Hayashi Iwokumo. No, that's not right. Iwokumo. There we go. Iwokumo. Thank you. Iwokumo. Again, young man from the Seattle Mariners. Yep, trying to do the best I can here with his name. Iwokumo, as he pitches a no-hitter for the Seattle Mariners. And first time that's happened in a long time in the American League. In fact, first time in 3 years there's been a no-no in the American League. He did it last night, again, for the Seattle Mariners. So congratulations to him. And that was a big, big night, obviously, for the Seattle Mariners. And got a chance to watch some of that ball game and some of the highlights. And so this is the, the fourth individual no-hitter in franchise history, becoming the oldest pitcher since Randy Johnson back in 2004 to throw a no-no. And so 11 straight no-hitters by National League pitchers, including three this season, Philadelphia's Cole Hamels, Washington's Max Scherzer, and San Francisco's Chris Heston. Last American League pitcher to keep zeros across the board was a teammate, Felix Hernandez, who tossed a no-hitter back in August. As a matter of fact, August 15th, 3 years to the day, August 15th, 2012. So, anyway, no-hitter last night in Major League Baseball thrown by the young man from the Seattle Mariners, Daniel Norris. How'd he do last night? Daniel Norris from Johnson City pitching for the Detroit Tigers. Not so bad. Went 6 1/3, so he was out there for a while. Kind of went deep into the ballgame. 6 hits, 4 runs, 3 of those earned, 3 walks, and a couple of strikeouts. So Daniel Norris, not bad, got a no decision. He actually, they won the ballgame 7-4, and the winning pitcher came in relief was Feliz, I guess it would be Feliz. And so he gets the winning relief, but Daniel Norris out of Johnson City, 6 1/3, 6 hits, 4 runs, 3 of those earned. And again, 3 walks and a couple of strikeouts, a no decision for Daniel Norris. Said yesterday he had to have a really good, outing, and I feel like he did enough to keep him around. I was under the impression, this is a gut feeling, had he had a bad outing yesterday, he may have been relegated to the AAA Detroit, because he'd had a good outing in Baltimore, got shelled against Boston, and now here in Kansas City last night, not bad. 6 1/3, 6 hits, 4 runs, 3 of those earned. He walked 3 and struck out 2. I mean, it's not lights out, being stretched of the imagination, but better than what he did last week against the Boston Red Sox. So, anyway, Daniel Norris pitching for Johnson City. Science Hill now moving on to the bigs, and from formerly Toronto and now with the Detroit Tigers, as you know by now, if you've listened to the show. And so he is finishing his third last night, his third starting assignment since becoming a Detroit Tiger. Is that correct? Let's see, Baltimore, Boston, yeah, Kansas City. So he'll rest it up, Wednesday, 5 more days, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. Probably the first of the week he'll get his next starting assignment for the Detroit, as my dad used to say, or Detroit, whichever one, Detroit Tigers of the American League. Good morning to you. Thanks for being with us, Tom Taylor Sports Show. It is a Thursday, day number 126 of our fun and frolic. And camera's still not right, is it? I still don't like it. I don't know what, something's not right. I can't figure out what it is, but I'm trying to lean forward, lean back. So this is, it's always something, as my father would say. The dust never settles. It's always something. By the way, did two quiz shows yesterday, went 2 for 5 with Landon Owen, the director of ticket sales at Bristol Motor Speedway, 2 for 5 with his college football questions. Didn't realize this. He gave me a really good question. Being a Marshall University Thundering Herd grad, the winningest college football team in the 90s was Marshall with 114 wins. I didn't know that. Division I, winningest football team in United States, U.S. of A., of course, would be and was the Thundering Herd of Marshall University. And so that was a nice trivia question, although I missed it. I went 2 for 5 with him, then came back with those really goofy questions from Elvis that they were songs that Elvis copied after someone else had sang them, and he went ahead and made hits with them. And that's what the trivia was about yesterday, and didn't do well there either, 2 for 5. And, of course, I got the boom from the Apester. So, anyway, we'll try that again next week. And tomorrow we've got our man Carmichael, who joins us later on the show today. See what's going on with Carmichael, and he'll join us right around 1 o'clock here this morning, or actually this afternoon. Also lined up, Daniel Monjay, big news out of Milligan College. We'll let him tell you all about that. He'll be joining us at noon. Also a little bit later on, Tim Smith, American Import and Auto Repair. He'll join us right around 12:30 today with some good news about your vehicle from American Import and Auto Repair, one of our great sponsors. Also you have, as we said, Carmichael, 1 o'clock. Jim Klein at 1:30, the big old tall drink of water, one of our great sponsors. Periodically, we put him on the show. And so these folks will be by coming up here a little bit later on the show. Also, we got some sports, lots of it to tell you about. Major League Baseball, some afternoon games today. Oakland will play at Toronto in a 12:30 start. Texas will be at Minnesota this afternoon. Tonight, under the lights, Yankees at Cleveland and the Angels in Kansas City. In the National League, we have games coming up this afternoon. Colorado and New York against the Mets. Cubbies will be at Wrigley against Milwaukee. Tonight under the lights, you have Pittsburgh at St. Louis. Reds leave San Diego, move on to open up a weekend series in L.A. against the Dodgers. And Washington will take on San Francisco out of the left coast. And a 10:15 start there tonight in Major League Baseball. PGA starts today. It is up and running. We'll try and keep you rolling on the leaderboard. As that unfolds here this morning and this afternoon. Rory McIlroy back 100% ready to go. And is returning from a left ankle injury. He was hurt early last month playing soccer with friends, in Northern Ireland. So Jordan Spieth trying to become the first player to win all three U.S. majors in the same year. Now, Zach Johnson won the British Open, putting the U.S. in position for its first major sweep since 1982. And so that's going on starting today in Wisconsin. So Masters U.S. Open champion Jordan Spieth trying to become the first player to win all three U.S. majors in the same year. I like to see him do it. He's won the Masters, U.S. Open, now going for the PGA of America, the championship, with a winner's share of $1.8 million if he wins it. That's how much he brings home to buy Pop-Tarts and Beanie Weenies. And so that's pretty cool stuff. That's a lot of money, and it's well worth it, obviously. Tom Taylor Sports Show, thanks for being with us again on this Thursday. What else happening in sports? Let's do a little pro football news for you. The Indianapolis Colts, of course, NFL preseason football kicks up big time tonight. T.Y. Hilton and the Colts agree to a 5-year, $65 million extension. All right? Indianapolis Colts and wide receiver T.Y. Hilton contract extension there. Again, Colts picking this young man up and is going to keep him on the staff, obviously on the team, not let him get away. And so he's going to be making some pretty good money, to say the least. $65 million total figures his deal. Fourth among wideouts behind Calvin Johnson, Dez Bryant, and Demarius Thomas. So, now, I don't know anything about T.Y. Hilton. He may be a heck of a football player. He's not a household name because I've not heard much about him. But apparently the Colts like him enough. They gave him big, big, big bucks. And so he's in. T.Y. Hilton signing a big contract with the Indianapolis Colts to stay there in Indianapolis for the next several years. What else happening in sports? I thought this was neat. You know, we always have bad stories. Not bad stories, but negative stories. Here's a good one. This is a story about an LSU receiver rescuing a trapped woman from an overturned vehicle, which I think is pretty cool stuff. LSU, wide receiver Travion Dural helped rescue a woman from an overturned vehicle in late July. Came across an overturned SUV at around 10 o'clock at night. SUV was in a ditch alongside the road. The doors were jammed with the driver's side door against the side of the six-foot-deep ditch. Driver was hanging upside down from her driver's seat, could not reach any of the other doors. Dural and a buddy of his, Randall Menard, his cousin, were the first two on the scene, and both had to pry open the rear passenger door. Once they did, they were able to pull the woman out of the vehicle unharmed. How about that? They said they first noticed the overturned SUV when the car lights flashed across it. Then he drove to a stop sign and turned around. So, nice stuff. How about a bell for these guys? Very nice. That would be Travin, T-R-A-V-I-N, Travin Dural, and his cousin Randall Menard. Couple of guys, and one of them, again, Dural, being a wide receiver with LSU and was a hero. Police showed up at the scene shortly after they pulled the woman from the car, and few of them recognized Dural and had pictures taken with him. How about that? People knew this guy's, hey, man, you just did a cool thing and have a picture taken with you? Yeah, I don't care. So he had his picture taken with him. That's pretty cool. Nice stuff. And so anyway, that happened at LSU back in July, and just now coming out because he didn't want to have a whole lot said about it. And so everybody kind of stayed hush-hush, but that kind of story is worth being put out there on the sports world, and we want to tell you all about those kind. Now, here's another story. We told you yesterday about our man who got released. Love this. Jets let him go. N. M. Pauley, young man who punched the jaw of Geno Smith and broke his jaw, as you know by now. We talked about this 2 days now. But anyway, the Bills and Jets are big rivals, right? Well, Rex Ryan, former coach of the Jets, now the Bills, went and got this guy. Put him on the team. The Jets shortly released him after the incident, which meant the second-year player became subjected to waivers, where the Bills claimed him. Buffalo Bills said, we want this guy. So, interesting to say the least, the Bills... N. M. Pauley will be reunited with Ryan, who coached the linebacker during his rookie year with the Jets back in 2014. So there's a little extra tweak there, of course. The Bills don't like the Jets. Jets don't like the Bills. Neither one of those like the Patriots. So there is that built-in rivalry in the AFC East. And so Jets coach Rex Ryan says, I'll take that guy. So he goes and gets him off waivers, and now he is a member of the Buffalo Bills. So interesting. And Geno Smith still with a broken jaw, and the Giants – or the Jets still trying to pick up the pieces and come up with a quarterback to make it go for him for the upcoming NFL season. Preseason football tonight. Here's who's playing where. Baltimore hosting the Saints. Green Bay goes to New England tonight to battle Mr. Brady, who will be playing apparently, and the Patriots. Jets will be in Detroit. See who their quarterback's going to be. They keep talking about Ryan Fitzpatrick. We'll see. Miami at Chicago taking on the Bears at Soldier Field. The Browns tonight hosting the Redskins. And Jason Witten and the Dallas Cowboys will be in San Diego to battle the Chargers. That's all tonight. Tomorrow night,
the Raiders.
My boys will be hosting the St. Louis Rams lunch bet. Got a lunch bet with Rob Cole from Bays Mountain Park. Big Rams fan. I said, Cole, they will mop you guys up off the field. The Raiders are back. He said, Tom, it's an exhibition. Cole, the Raiders will mop your guys off the mat. You kidding me? And so the Raiders and the Rams play tomorrow night. First of, four or five exhibition games, getting ready for the season opener coming up in early September for the National Football League. It's the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Thanks for being with us here again on this Thursday. Again, August 15th? Is that right? August 15th? August 13th. I don't know where I got the 15th. August the 13th. Write that down. August the 13th. Kind of moving things along. By the way, here in the Tri-Cities this morning, woke up. Was it nice or was it nice? Had a little, just a little twinge of fall in the air. Very, very nice. Going to warm back up, but beautiful morning. And so far, I've got four August mornings that have been foggy here in the immediate Tri-Cities, which the old farmers tell every foggy morning will translate into a snowstorm or snow event. And so I got four right now. And so if that's the case, we're going to get a lot of snow here, at least four snow events coming up in the winter of 2014. So for the whole month of August, every foggy morning represents, that's an old farmer's tale, a snow event. And the thicker the fog, the heavier the snow is going to be. So right now, I've got four snow events. We've had four, I would call it legitimate, foggy mornings. And so that's We'll keep an eye on that. This morning wasn't, but we've got four so far here in the first 13 days of 2015. You may think there's more, but I kind of go with four. So anyway, that's what we got. That's what's going on there. Quick break. We'll be right back. Again, it is the Tom Taylor Sports Show again on this Thursday. We thank you for being with us. You're home for Science Hill football coming up a week from Friday. Hard to believe. 2 weeks from Friday. All right. Yeah, 2 weeks from Friday. Not a week, but 2 weeks from Friday. I want to rush it. But we do have football coming up in 2 weeks, and it'll be the Science Hill Hilltoppers and the Elizabethan Cyclones ready to go, and we're looking forward to that, to say the least. So let's see what we got here. We have Gator sending me something already. Gator, bring on the snow. Gator, 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 watch what you say, son. How could you say that? Bring on the snow. All these people this summer, I can't believe how hot it is. And I say the same thing every time. In February that morning, it was 9 below and snow. Ain't complaining about the no heat for this cowboy. I'm all right. I'd rather have the heat easier for me to cool down than it is for me to heat up. So Gator says, bring on the snow. Shamey, shamey, shamey is what I would say to that. It's the Tom Taylor Sports Show again on this Thursday. Quick break. We'll be right back from one of our great sponsors, Bristol Orthotics and Prosthetics, soon to be opening a brand new office in Johnson City on Springbrook Drive in the Peerless Center. Will's all excited about that. We're going to be talking to him next week. We'll be here tomorrow, then Monday and Tuesday, and then we step aside next Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. We'll shut this down totally, and we'll be live from Bristol Motor Speedway, Bristol Live, and of course, he's going to be on that show as well, one of our great sponsors. And so we just picked up, I'm awful excited about this, Blue Lizard Australian sunscreen, and I'm all about Blue Lizard. It's made right here in the Tri-Cities in Johnson City, shipped all over the world. I was talking to Jeff the other day. We're going to have him on the show, and what was he telling me? 25 countries has now marketed him, along with the United States. I love it. Made right here in the Tri-Cities. Here's my soapbox. Please support these folks. Be loyal. Buy local. Here's the products made here in the Johnson City, Tri-Cities area, shipped all over the world. It is a good, good product. Very good product. I stand behind it, whether the guy advertises with me or not. I believe in the product. So please support these folks and buy Blue Lizard wherever you can. Australian sunscreen. And it works. And we appreciate them very, very much. And they're going to be with us starting, what is this, Thursday? Starting Monday. They'll be on the show as a sponsor. And they're also going to be on the Bristol Live. Very excited about that. So we continue to grow the show, and that's what it's all about. And we appreciate folks like you giving us a listen. Nice feedback from the Facebook yesterday. Horace took those pictures and got them out of Gary Mabry and, gosh, who else we had on? Landon Owen and Brandon Cross. And, of course, Tommy Wyman came by and Drew Bedard. They all were there as part of the show. And he took the pictures, put them out on Facebook. This thing's been popping all afternoon, all evening last night, and even this morning, liking the photos. So thanks to Horace, and thank you for checking us out on Facebook. Quick break. We'll be right back. It is a Thursday. More coming on the Tom Taylor Sports Show.
At Bristol Orthotics and Prosthetics, they treat thousands of patients each year dealing with diabetes and its effects. Diabetes overtaking our nation and leaving a path of destruction behind. Through wound care, office visits, and preventive care, they see most of their patients after a problem arises. Using diabetic footwear, such as shoes and inserts, a great way to prevent or prolong skin breakdown and amputation. At Bristol Orthotics and Prosthetics, they use only custom molds from patient mold inserts, which further ensure a great recovery, or better yet, prevents a wound from happening. They use custom molded shoes, bracing, custom inserts, and extra depth diabetic shoes to prevent wounds or other skin issues from beginning. Call today, 1-800-524-4447. 39 years, 6 locations, 1 family. Bristol Orthotics and Prosthetics, 1-800-524-4447.
It's Friday night at 7 o'clock. You've been involved in a car accident. You may be out of state on vacation or just a few miles from home. What do you do? Who do you call? At Farmers Insurance Group, one call is all you have to make. Hello, this is Jim Klein, an agent with Farmers Insurance. It's called One and Done. You don't have to wait till Monday morning to file a claim. You can make the initial call, and we begin right away to help you. We assist you in moving the vehicle to a certified repair shop, getting you set up with rental car, and informing your agent. Then here at the staff at Jim Klein Farmers Insurance, we follow the claim through to the end. It's that easy. One and done. We're your one and done location for all your insurance needs. Auto, home, life, commercial, workers' comp, and bonds. We can help you with all your insurance needs. Give me a call today, Jim Klein, Jim Klein Farmers Insurance at 247-5400. Your one-and-done location in Kingsport, 247-5400.
From the driveways where your kids play basketball and ride their bicycles to the parking lots at your local church or grocery store, Bracken Paving is an important part of many neighborhoods in our area. No matter how large or how small the job, Bracken strives for excellence in every service they provide. It's a foundation for a strong community. Discover the difference at Bracken Paving and Asphalt Maintenance. Give us a call or visit us online at brackenpaving.com.
Your life is always changing. You never know what shape it will take or how your financial needs might change. But if we talk about your investments and how they can provide for you and your family, the future becomes clear. At Wells Fargo Advisors, we believe conversation leads to financial clarity. Let's start a conversation today.
Show. Thanks for being with us again on this Thursday. Yeah. Love that music. Boom. Bullseye. Yeah. Ooh, I like it. A little bullseye action. All right, let's see what's happening in the National Football League. Aaron Rodgers, quarterback of the Green Bay Packers, not happy, not pleased with the NFL's decision to move back point after attempts from the 2-yard line to the 15-yard line. New rule this year, I don't know if you knew that. Moving the point afters in NFL football from the 2-yard line to the 15-yard line. Rodgers says not just because he plays the Packers, but the weather can challenge kickers when they line up for a, in this case, a 33-yard extra point. According to the new rule, Rodgers says allows the defense to score, goes against the league's stance on player safety. It's a live football now. It's now become a very important play, especially in the wintertime in Green Bay when no field goal is guaranteed. Well, it should be. It shouldn't be an automatic. It shouldn't be a gimme. It should be a challenge. Should be some risk involved in a point after, not a chip shot automatic. What was the last year? I read where it was like 92% completion rate last year. Well, it shouldn't be that way. It should be, and I don't know if you go back to the 15-yard line, but 2-yard line is 2-yard line rather is way too easy. He says, quote, it doesn't just go for Green Bay any place that is cold or has rain or inclement weather. It's going to be an interesting decision. Should be. Adds to the element of the ball game. Instead of going, okay, 2 points, 2-point conversion. I'm sorry, point after, 2-yard line. It's automatic. Shouldn't be that way. I disagree with him. Any place that is cold or has rain or inclement weather is going to be an interesting decision. Do you go for the 2-pointer from the 2, or do you go for a 33-yard field goal? Well, that's, there again, that plays into the strategy, makes it more interesting for the fans. For the players, a lot more at stake than an automatic chip shot for the extra point. And with that, the play's not dead anymore. That's exactly right. If there's an interception or a fumble, you can return it. Exactly. Which adds to the excitement of the game. I applaud the NFL. So I think you're bringing some player safety issues involved in that play. I don't. It could make it more exciting. It will. But I still like the 1-pointer from where it was at. Okay. Rodgers isn't the only one displeased with the change in rules. The new rule was first announced. Bills kicker Dan Carpenter spoke out against the change. Interestingly enough, he cited the same two reasons as Rodgers. But again, from my money, as a fan, and as just from the element of, not surprise, but the element of challenge for the sport, now you're kicking a 15-yard point after, and in essence becomes a 33-yard extra point. Or do you go for the 2 points and line up and run the 2 points? To me, it's good. It's good for football. It's good for the fans. It now brings more strategy into the football game because now you have to consider when you make these touchdowns, do you go to the next round? Do you do the 15-yard line point after, or do you set up and run for the 2-point? I think it's good. Rodgers says no. I disagree. I think it's good for the fans. I think it's good for the sport. And, again, it brings, to me, the strategy back into the game a little bit more than it was instead of being an automatic, virtually a chip shot. for the point afters in the National Football League. Florida State linebacker Matthew Thomas' career with the Seminoles been anything but smooth. Another problem at Florida State. There's some more today. It's really sad. I mean, this tends to be the norm instead of the exception now. Our guys are doing stupid things, getting in trouble. We've got three that are out there. Let's see. I actually got more than that. We've got several out there that are stepping away from their team. They're transferring. I see that a lot. A lot of guys leaving. Let's see. We'll get to those guys in a moment. Florida State linebacker Matthew Thomas here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Career with the Seminoles, anything but smooth. He is now ineligible to play for Florida State in 2015 because of an unspecified violation of NCAA rules. Coming from the Orlando Sentinel newspaper also notes that Thomas has not been present at preseason camp and was not in the team photos taken over the weekend. So he was suspended for the first half of the season over an NCAA rules issue and battled injuries the remainder of the campaign. So he is out. Hopeful they'll get him back to be ready to go for spring practice in 2016. But a pretty good football player, five-star prospect, linebacker Matthew Thomas of the Florida State Seminoles, not ready to go and can go for the Seminoles of Jimbo Fisher. What else happening? Let's see. We got Michigan State linebacker Davis out for the season with a knee injury. Clemson defensive back Wiggins out for the season with a torn ACL. Of course, we told you about Jackson, the starting Tennessee offensive guard, could miss all of the season, all of 2015. So, got some guys getting banged up in preseason, which is part of it. Unfortunately, it's the attrition rate. But we got some big-name guys not going to be able to go in 2015 because of injuries. And so, a guy told me yesterday, he said, listen to the show, he said, are you sure Jackson's out? I said, well, they're talking to Deshaun Robertson to change his uniform number from his to Jackson's to wear his number in his honor for the season. So if you're hurt and I'm going to wear your jersey because you're hurt for the rest of the season, that would tell me you ain't coming back because they're switching jerseys. So that's the latest. Again, could miss all of 2015. Jackson, the big offensive guard, as we said yesterday on the show, Bristol Motor Speedway, the last thing Butch Jones needs was that. He has an offensive line that was leaky at best anyway last year. Again, 43 sacks. They gave up last season, the most in the Southeastern Conference. Only four other schools in the country had more quarterback sacks because of a leaky offensive line than Tennessee. He was one of the mainstays. Now he's out, apparently, for the season. So that is a big blow for the Tennessee Volunteers. Tom Taylor Sports Show, thanks for being with us. Again, Facebook us, like us, and follow us if you do. Facebook.com/The Tom Taylor Sports Show. Dan Mullen, the coach of Mississippi State, he's not happy. He's got a little beef today. I tend to agree with him here. I don't agree with everybody, but I tend to agree with this one. I disagree with Aaron Rodgers on that point after. I agree with this guy, the coach of Mississippi State, the Bulldogs, and Southern Miss. This is not a misprint. They're going to kick the football game off at 9 o'clock Mississippi time. Now, that's week one. Week two, with their home game against LSU, is a 9:15 kickoff on Saturday night. Mullen, the coach of Mississippi State, is not thrilled with the situation. Quote, the schedule changes how we prepare because we play at like midnight every kickoff. It is hard. Our first two games, you expect, are still going to be going on past midnight, which is kind of ridiculous, but that's just the way it is. I would think so. They both kick off at 9 o'clock, 60 minutes plus a halftime. I can see it being right at 11:30 midnight before it's over with. That will change how we prepare closer to game week because I'm usually asleep by then. I've got to be rocking and rolling in the fourth quarter. Our guys aren't used to physically performing at that point in the night. Mullen then pointed out that by NCAA rules, his players aren't allowed to be used to physically perform at that time of day. I didn't realize that. Quote, we used to train them at midnight in the summer, and the NCAA outlawed that. You can't do that anymore, but they'll let us play after midnight, which is kind of ridiculous. I guess we should petition the NCAA. If they're going to let us play after midnight, they should let us practice and train after midnight. Mullen has an argument. Players' internal body clocks can absolutely have an effect on an in-game performance. Ask anyone who's watched a West Coast team slog through an early East Coast kickoff. On the other hand, at least Mullen can console himself with the fact that neither Southern Miss nor LSU will be permitted to have practices that late either. And perhaps more to the point, those late kickoffs aren't decided by whim. The Bulldogs are playing the games that late because the games will be on television that way, and it's safe to assume, certainly in the case of the Southern Miss game, that playing them earlier would mean far less exposure or possibly a lack of television coverage in its entirety. So there you go. There is a reason why they're playing. It's for television. 9 o'clock against Southern Miss, 9:15 against LSU. It gives you exposure. Exposure gives you attention. Attention gives you more exposure to potential recruits, alumni base all over the country can watch you play late at night. So Mullen's complaint will draw plenty of sympathy from SEC coaches who've been griping for years about attending games that end in the wee hours and forcing them to arrive home in the wee hours of the morning on a plane when they fly back to their school. But the Southeastern Conference collectively decided years ago that it would live with the consequences for in-stadium fans in exchange for the exposure and the profits television could offer. It's all about the money. So anyway, Dan Mullen not happy at Mississippi State because his first two games are kickoffs at 9 o'clock Mississippi time against Southern Miss and LSU. So, and I think he has a point. But he also says the SEC knows that we're going to bite the bullet, play that and that point on Saturday evening to get the money and the exposure on television. So I guess I don't know why he's complaining because he knows that. SEC is the conference in college football, so anytime they can play to get the exposure, they're going to play. And you look at the SEC network, I mean, it is the conference in college football, no question. So when you're in there and part of that number one conference, it just goes without saying that you're going to be doing some things other conferences won't get to do and won't get the exposure either. So it's kind of a double-edged sword, but that's Dan Mullen from Mississippi State. Tom Taylor Sports Show. On a sad note, pro basketball, Minnesota Timberwolves have announced coach and president of basketball operations Flip Saunders diagnosed with Hodgkin's lymphoma. Very treatable, a curable form of cancer, currently undergoing chemo treatment for it. He was diagnosed 8 weeks ago and immediately started undergoing treatment at the Mayo Clinic. He will continue his duties in the front office and coaching during this process. Again, Minnesota Timberwolves coach and president of basketball operations, Flip Saunders, diagnosed with Hodgkin's lymphoma, but it's very treatable and curable, and he's undergoing chemo treatments at the Mayo Clinic. So best wishes to Flip Saunders. Tom Taylor Sports Show, thanks for being with us again on this Thursday, August the 13th, 2015. We got a really good thought for the day. They're all good, but this is a really good one. And we'll talk to you about that coming up here in a few minutes. Compliments and courtesy of our buddy Larry Kaiser at Larry Kaiser Nationwide Insurance. Something's not right about this camera. I still don't, because every time I look down, I got to look down to read this stuff. I can't see the head. Maybe that's good. You can't see me. Maybe a good thing. Just seems, I keep looking at this camera thing and the screen here. Boy, I like that sign back there, by the way. Interstate Graphics and Design, thank you, Trevor Bartley. Good job, my friend, up in Pawnee Flats. Bluff City did that, and that looks really sharp, and we thank you. Even there on the bottom right-hand corner, you see the icons for TuneIn, iTunes Radio, and YouTube. Thank you, my friend. Over to the right, you see
the Raiders.
All you need to see is that symbol. Up above it, Super Bowl champions, doesn't matter. All you see is that, you see the symbol. That's all you need to see. Then you see the Tennessee, Power T, ETSU, and the Thundering Herd. To my left or my left shoulder, you see the big Milligan College M, and we're going to never get slowed down long enough to do what I need to do, but we're going to get some better lighting in here for tomorrow's show. Here tomorrow, then Monday and Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, we'll park it. We'll be again at Bristol Motor Speedway doing the Bristol Live Show. Can't wait. 4 days, jam-packed, brought to you by Yates Nationwide Agency, Food City, also by our good friends at Chick-fil-A and the Crossings in North Johnson City. Other great sponsors, Tim Smith and the folks, American Import and Auto Repair, Blue Lizard, Australian Sunscreen, also going to be brought to you by Bracket Asphalt Maintenance and Paving. Who else? There's a bunch of them. I can't remember them all. I haven't written down, but we'll be there starting next Wednesday. Of course, a week from today, we'll be in downtown Bristol, really off property, as we get ready for Food City Family Race Night. A week from tonight in downtown Bristol, they're going to be, guess who? Guess who they're going to honor coming up next week? What logical NASCAR driver would you want to honor and do a Q&A with? Let me think. The hottest driver on the circuit, Kyle Busch. Yeah, where is it? I'm all about it. My man's going to be down there next week in downtown Bristol. I'm going to try every way in the world to get up there and get an interview with my man they call Rowdy. Although, I will say this, looks like he's mellowed a bit. That wreck, I think, has kind of slowed him down from his temper, and I think having getting married to Samantha and having his first child, I think that slows you down, mellows you out a little bit. It really does. If you're a parent or grandparent, you know things used to really matter. It's like, really? Nah. You know, we got bigger fish to fry. We got a wife, in his case, and we've got a newborn. And then, of course, you know, he's be the first to tell you he's very fortunate to be back even driving a race car, let alone walking the way that injury was down at Daytona back in February. So I see, and I watch him all the time, I see a mellowing. Yeah, because even he's had a couple of times, I was going to say, as long as you're winning, everything's good. You're always going to be in a good mood. But there's been a couple of races where he's got bumped and knocked, particularly in the Xfinity Series, and the old Kyle Busch would have snapped and really popped off. And the new ones kind of went, eh, all right, whatever. And I see that. Also see it for a different reason and for a sadder reason for Tony Stewart. Tony, again, still dealing, I know the civil lawsuit came out this week. The family's going to sue him. And so, I mean, it's, you know, it's pretty tough. It's not going to go away. And when you do what he did, right or wrong, not right or wrong, you do what he did, I can't imagine there doesn't be an hour or a day go by he doesn't think about that when you've cost somebody their life. And so the family's going to sue him. And so Tony is not the same guy either. I don't hear the fieriness that I once heard. And, of course, that happens when you get a little bit older anyway. You just start mellowing and, as Mama used to say, pick your fights. And I think that's to a large point is what's going on with Tony Stewart. Plus, he's having a terrible year. And on top of that, of course, what happened last year. So all that being said, a mellower, if you will, more mellower, Kyle Busch will be in Bristol next week. We'll be downtown for the Food City Family Race Night, roaming around and broadcasting from there. And, of course, Bristol Live starts next Wednesday, inside of a week now. Again, that doubleheader. And, again, tickets are on sale, bristoltix.com, T-I-X, and also 423-BRISTOL to get your tickets for the doubleheader. As you heard yesterday, if you missed it, Brandon Cross said, in between the two races, I'm kind of jacked up to see these guys, really. In between the two races is going to be the FMX Motorcycle Group. There's three of these folks come in here doing, they take off on the ramp, go up and do flips in the air and come back down. This is going to be on the front stretch or the back stretch of the speedway on concrete. Be pretty cool. I want to see that myself. That's going to be between the Busch Beans 150, the Whelen Modified Tour Race, then the break for the FMX bikers. What do you call them? The sports site motorcyclist? Freestyle motorcyclist will be in between. And then the second half of the doubleheader will be the Camping World Truck Series UNOH 200, brought to you by or sponsored by, presented by Zaloop. And Brad Kozlowski will be the defending champ of that race. So all that's coming up next Wednesday night. So even more of an incentive to check out those motorcycle folks. Should be a lot of fun. Tom Taylor Sports Show, let's run down football. Football week away here in Northeast Tennessee. Tomorrow, Science Hill, the Hilltoppers, take their show on the road to battle a very good Knox Catholic team and a scrimmage down in Knoxville tomorrow. Final tune-up for their season as the Hilltoppers get ready to go 2 weeks from tomorrow. They'll be taking on the Elizabethan Cyclones, and that'll be happening at Kermit Tipton Stadium. 6A football, we mentioned, there they are, Science Hill, the other teams in the 6A. Alphabetically are Bearden, Knox Bearden, Bradley Central, Dobbins Minute, Hardin Valley, Jefferson County, Maryville, Science Hill, and William Blount. That's 6A. 5A this year, alphabetically, Cock County, Daniel Boone, David Crockett, Morristown East, Morristown West, Sevier County, and Tennessee High. 4A, Cherokee, Granger, Greenville, Seymour. That's a good conference there. That ought to be a good one. Cherokee, 5A, I don't know about that one. Sevier County ought to be the daddy rabbit in that conference, I would think. Don't know about Morristown East, Morristown West. Typically, they have very athletic teams. Tennessee High, don't know much about them. They should be fairly athletic. Daniel Boone should be athletic. Crockett should be better. Yeah, it's going to be an okay conference. The 4A ought to be a dandy. Cherokee, Greenville, Seymour. It's been getting strong lately. Sullivan Central, you're talking about a new, exciting football program. They're getting a chance to compete now and not get their brains beat out. They had no business being at a conference last year. That was a stupid move by the TSSAA, as far as I'm concerned. They had a chance to let them stay down, what was it, 2 or 3 student differential. They could stay, play down to more of a competitive situation like they are in now. And, of course, the brain trust at TSSAA said no. So Central took one for the team for a couple of years, but now they're in this new conference where they can compete. Sullivan East, a very good football team. Sullivan South, probably in a rebuilding mode, and volunteer. They lost a lot of people last year, the Rebels. In fact, the statistic that Sam Haney said at the football banquet last year, earlier this year, was only one touchdown was scored last year by an underclassman. Everybody else that scored points for Sullivan South were seniors. They're gone, obviously. So they're in a rebuilding mode at South and in Volunteer with a new coach. And that's going to be a good conference. 4A should be a really, really good conference. Cherokee, Granger, Greenville, you know, they're going to be strong. Seymour, Sullivan Central, Sullivan East, Sullivan South, and Volunteer. That's a really good conference. Kudos to the TSSAA for doing that one right. 3A, let's see. This is Elizabethan all the way. I don't see anybody challenging these guys. Maybe Pigeon Forge. I don't know what. Sometimes they got a pretty good football team. 3A, you've got Elizabethan, but alphabetically, Chucky Doak, Claiborne, Elizabethan, Johnson County, Northview Academy out of Kodiak, Tennessee, Pigeon Forge, Unicoi County in the rebuilding mode, and West Green. They're going to be better, Unicoi County, but I don't know if they can challenge for the conference championship. That is clearly what I'm reading here, and not knowing anything about anybody, going on their past performance and their past reputation as a football program. Elizabethan is the king in that one. And Pigeon Forge, maybe give them a run for the money, but after that, I think you can put them in a sack and shake them up. 2A football in Northeast Tennessee. Alphabetically, Cosby, Cumberland Gap, Gatlinburg-Pittman, the Hampton Bulldogs, Happy Valley will be improved. They're dropping down. By the way, our buddy Bernie Young is now the principal at Happy Valley High School. Bernie, great guy. Love working with him. You're talking about first class. When you get over to Happy Valley, he makes you feel welcome when you go there to broadcast. And so he is now the principal. What was her name? Mrs. Hubbard. I don't think that's it. Very, very nice lady. Moved to the central office in the Carter County School District. It was Hubbard. Pretty sure it was Hubbard. What a very nice lady. But anyway, she is bumped up, and Bernie Young elevated the principal now at Happy Valley. They're in this conference. North Green, South Green, and Sullivan North. Pretty good conference there. 2A, Cosby, Cumberland Gap, Gatlinburg, Pittman, Hampton, Happy Valley, North Green, South Green, and Sullivan North. So those are the teams in 2A. In single A, Cloudland, Concord Christian, know nothing about them. Hancock County, Oakdale, and Unaka are the teams in 1A. Not a bad conference either. So really, for my money, they're all pretty good. But I think 4A really jumps out at me as a good conference. And 5A, that's not going to be bad. Sevier County is going to be very strong in 5A. Remains to be seen if Crockett, as we talked yesterday, if they can get them all singing off the same page after the hazing incident and the suspension of the kids off that team. Again, Coach Boskin has to rally the troops. I'm sure he can, but that'll, in my opinion, in large part determine how far they go this season. So Cock County, Daniel Boone, Crockett, Morristown East, Morristown West, Sevier County, and Tennessee High. That's a pretty strong conference. And then 6A, of course, we're bringing you Science Hill Hilltopper football. They'll oppose Bearden, Bradley Central, Dobbins Bennett, Hardin Valley Academy, Jefferson County, Maryville, and William Blount. That's a strong conference as well. So, really, on a 1 to 10, 1 being terrible, 10 being good job, TSSAA. I would rate those, I guess, if I had to rate them. I would rate the overall, putting together the conferences, 7, 7.5, maybe an 8. It's not perfect. But, again, it's so big geographically. I mean, look at 6A. Well, everybody knows that story. But look at 5A. Newport, Gray, Jonesboro, Morristown, Sevierville, and Bristol. You go from Bristol down to Sevierville. That's a long haul. But it's all based on enrollment of the school, so you don't really have a choice. 4A football, geographically speaking, you go from Rutledge up to Bluff City. You go from Granger County to Sullivan East. That's a haul, to say the least, if you ever traveled that. 3A, pretty good distance as well. You go to Claiborne, from Claiborne County all the way up to Johnson County. So from New Tazewell, Tennessee to Mountain City, that's a haul. So, you know, and you say, okay, what's the big deal? But if you've traveled, let's put you and I in a vehicle, and let's get on a school bus, and we're going to travel, I don't know, what are some of these drives? A couple of hours? All right. You know how you've driven for a couple of hours. You want to stop and get out and stretch? Well, these guys don't get out and stretch. They get out and stretch, play a football game. I mean, yes, they're younger, and yes, they're in better shape, but still, your body sitting on a bus for a couple of hours and then you get off and have to stretch and get ready to play a football game. Pretty tough to do. And so I think in any of these conferences, when they're traveling, advantage to any team that is home, you have an immediate advantage based on the travel and the distance these teams have to go to play each other. So if you're a home team in any of these games, I think you got a leg up right out of the chute. I'm going to say, wouldn't say you're a touchdown better. I'd say you're 3 or 4 points better right out of the chute. I'm going to give you 3 or 4 points because you're at home and not have to get on those buses and travel. Now, granted, they stop, they eat, they relax, they try and stretch. They just don't get on the bus and go from point A to point B. At least the bigger schools don't. I don't know if the smaller schools have the budget to do that or not, but the big boys will stop and stretch and eat and get a pregame meal and so on and so forth. So still, if you're traveling, I give advantage to the home team. I'll give you 3 or 4 points right out of the chute simply because all you're going to do is drive across town from your home and, get in the locker room, lay back, relax, and be ready to go. So I think definite advantage to the home team. Tom Taylor Sports Show, again, thanks for being with us again on this Thursday. Coming up, Michigan. We got a story about Michigan. The Wolverines got a story about Steve Spurrier. Yeah, I love it. This guy's awesome. Whether you like him or not, this guy is awesome. Let me just say this. Having been involved now the last 5 or 6 weeks with the Science Hill sports family, Steve Spurrier loves Science Hill. And you know that. That's kind of a duh. But better yet, Steve Spurrier loves not just the student-athlete. He loves Science Hill. He's done some things that behind the scenes that are helping not just the athletes, but also the, I call them the mainstream student-athlete. Or students, I should say, at Science Hill. So Steve Spurrier has not forgot his roots and where he came from. So whether you like him or not, I think that's very important. And he is continuing to support in several ways, including financially, the efforts being made at Science Hill. So I applaud Steve Spurrier because he has not forgot where he came from. And that's Johnson City, Tennessee. And if you ever hear his story, it's pretty interesting how, they didn't have a whole lot, but he worked himself from what he did have growing up to where he is now at South Carolina. So pretty cool story. Anyway, he has got a story about him coming up. Also a story about the Michigan Wolverines. Also, let's see, what else up and down through here? Here's another story about the Michigan Wolverines. See, folks say you just pick on Florida State. No, just don't pick on Florida State. They just happen to be in the news a lot. But we got a couple of stories about Michigan going on here. And so we'll talk about that coming up here in a few minutes. Also, on the Tom Taylor Sports Show, our first guest comes up at the top of the hour, and that will be coming up, 10 minutes, Daniel Monge from Milligan College. Big news for their baseball team. I don't know if you've heard this, but big news. Pretty cool stuff. And so we'll check in with Monge, see what's going on coming up here in a little while. Also, Carmichael joins us a little bit later on here in the Tom Taylor Sports Show. First, take a quick break. Our buddy just saw him a few minutes ago. Tim Smith from American Import and Auto Repair. In fact, he'll join us coming up on the show a little bit later on. Summertime care. Are you traveling across the Tri-Cities or across the region or across the state or across the country? Got to have your vehicle in tip-top shape. One of our great sponsors, and he will talk to us about water pumps, timing belts, some of those things that you don't always think about. You always think about oil changes, the basic stuff, windshield wiper replacements, those kind of things, which are very, very important. But sometimes the big stuff, you need to check those out as well. He joins us coming up in a little while. First, let's hear from him. Right here, my man, Tim Smith, American Import and Auto Repair on the Tom Taylor Sports Show.
At American Import and Auto Repair in Johnson City, one of the 8 areas of your vehicle that takes constant continuing education is the air conditioner on your vehicle.
Well, you would think that AC would be a simple one, but it's getting to be a lot bigger than just AC. It's the management of the system, not just AC, but heat and everything. It's a lot more computer controlled than it used to be. It used to be just a little button on the dash that you pushed. Now there's all kinds of electronics involved in that. Braking systems used to be fairly simple. Now some of the newer vehicles, you have to have a computer to actually operate the braking system to make sure that it's okay after you've worked on it. Computer controlled of the engine is becoming very important. There's a lot to that. Each one of these areas, the technology has just tripled and quadrupled in the last few years. It's hard to keep up. You really need to stay in the books and know what's going on with them.
American Import and Auto Repair, Johnson City, open 6 days a week. Call today at 913-3111.
It's Friday night at 7 o'clock. You've been involved in a car accident. You may be out of state on vacation or just a few miles from home. What do you do? Who do you call? At Farmers Insurance Group, one call is all you have to make. Hello, this is Jim Klein, an agent with Farmers Insurance. It's called One and Done. You don't have to wait till Monday morning to file a claim. You can make the initial call, and we begin right away to help you. We assist you in moving the vehicle to a certified repair shop, getting you set up with rental car, and informing your agent. Then here at the staff at Jim Klein Farmers Insurance, we follow the claim through to the end. It's that easy. One and Done. We're your one and done location for all your insurance needs. Auto, home, life, commercial, workers' comp, and bonds. We can help you with all your insurance needs. Give me a call today, Jim Klein, Jim Klein Farmers Insurance at 247-5400. Your one and done location in Kingsport, 247-5400.
Kingsport Cabinetry installs cabinets and countertops all over the three-state region. Owner Richard Isaac says there is no charge for his quotes.
All of our quotes and drawings are free. I know a lot of the national chains, big box stores and stuff, and I understand they have to charge a price to come out and measure and do a quote, but here at Kingsport Cabinetry, we do all that for free in hopes that our service is good enough. I always tell people this, Tom. I say, you can go anywhere in this town and get a product like I have, but find somebody you're comfortable working with. If you're not comfortable working with me, find somebody you are comfortable working with. But I can guarantee you we'll give you the service. We have a full shop back here that we do custom work, and I'll just move on a little bit. We get into commercial work. We do a lot of commercial work, a lot of healthcare, a lot of restaurants, banks, schools, things like that too.
Kingsport Cabinetry. Call Richard Isaacs today at 247-6134.
Whoops, back on the Tom Clutter Sports Show, the wrong one turned up. Thanks for being with us here again on this Thursday as we work our way through this 13th day of August, 2015. And here we go, it's a little bit better. Fixed that camera during the break where I can let's see the top of my head all the time. So, and that's okay. That's, if you see the top of my head, see the top of the hat. But I'll give you a little bit of chance to see a little bit more of what's going on in this beautiful backdrop. I like this. Up behind us is the scoreboard. How about that? See a big fat nine up there? Yeah, went 5 for 5 on Monday, smoked it. Thank you, Gator. No, it wasn't Gator. Tuesday, thank you, Richard Isaacs. Gator gave me that Zamboni question. God, pitiful. Oh, even the guys at the Speedway yesterday said, he gave you a question about what? I said, the Zamboni machine. Really? I said, yeah. Oh, yeah. So that's our boy, the Gator man. And so anyway, we went 5 for 5 on Tuesday, 1 for Natalie Brooks, 9's up there now, 13 all told on the Bracken Paving Asphalt maintenance scoreboard. You see it up behind, right above the Milligan logo. Then you see, thanks to that great sign job done by Trevor Bartley. See, Tom, it's just a sign. Yeah, he did a good job on a short notice. Tom Taylor Sports Show, thank you. On livestream.com, the Hat Blocks live stream, but you, if you're with us at this point, you know where I'm at. To the right, of course, is the cross. I got to fix that. I got to bring it, drop it down so you can see it. Because that's what this show's all about. Unashamedly, you see the tent in the bottom of it, right beside the Raiders logo. But anyway, and of course, the Power Tee and ETSU, so we'll tweak that a little bit. I think I'll leave it like this, and I'll move that cross down below the Thundering Herd so you can see it very prominently right here on the wall. So anyway, we unashamedly dedicate this show to the man who hung on the cross. Again, our Bible verse of the day, John 3:16, pretty basic, the key to the whole book. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Didn't have to. He gave him as a gift. That whosoever, that be me, you, someone in Iceland, someone in Thailand, someone in Africa, someone Rio de Janeiro, pick a place. Whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, which means spend your eternity in hell, but have everlasting life, which means you'll spend your life, your eternal life in heaven. By the way, as I get into preaching, just here's a news flash. You and I are going to spend somewhere forever. It'd be your choice, but we are going to spend someplace forever. Just that simple. All right, NASCAR news. NASCAR has addressed the heat issues that plagued last month's racing in Indianapolis with a rules mandate for this weekend in Michigan. Drivers complaining it was too hot in the cockpit of their cars with a high drag rules package which was first used in Indianapolis and will return to Michigan. The package reduces airflow under the car, so heat is trapped in the cockpit, and several drivers were almost ill following the Xfinity Series race in Indy. So NASCAR mandating a dual outlet duct to be used on the right side window to help ventilate the cockpit. A day before the mandate, Brad Keselowski said Sunday's race in Michigan could be the toughest race probably of the year physically. Yeah, you wait to get up here next week in the heat and humidity on a muggy Saturday night in Bristol at the world's last great Coliseum. Heat's going to be even worse this weekend, he said. There is a large amount of concern across both teams and the driver of this rules package coming up from Michigan. Even though the track is wider and bigger, the significance of the draft is going to be even more important. So you're going to have to stay in line as much as possible. Keselowski goes on to say, as you stay in line, the car gets less and less air because that's essentially how the draft works. So, fastest track in NASCAR, by the way, is where? It's in Michigan. So, Keselowski warns that high drag packages will cause parts to overheat, particularly in the drivetrain. Cars topping 200 miles per hour at Michigan in qualifying, and temperatures are expected to be in the mid-80s on Sunday. So anyway, they're talking about now they're going to mandate a dual outlet duct to be used on the right side window, which is, for you and I, the passenger side window, to help ventilate the cockpit. Now you imagine the heat coming off that car, and now the heat does not escape like they had it before with this new rules package. It stays in the car. Wow. So that would be. That would be very tough. You and I have air conditioning. They don't have air conditioning. Yeah, they're making big bucks. Okay. That's kind of lame. They're making big bucks, but they still are you and I. They're still people, and they still sweat and still get sick from the heat. So could be interesting in Michigan. It may be a nutrition factor simply because of the heat at Michigan this weekend. It'll be hot coming up at Bristol Motor Speedway in more ways than one, I can tell you that. I cannot wait for the racing next week. I wish it was here now. There is going to be some serious, serious racing going on next week. Chase is coming down. You've got guys like Busch. They got to get in Kyle Busch. He's got all those wins, but he has to get in through points as well. Jeff Gordon's making his farewell run around Bristol. I mean, what a Cinderella story. He's not exactly had a superstar year for Jeff Gordon and hit Jeff Gordon measurements, if you will. So what a better way for him to wrap up his last stop in Bristol than to bring home the checkers. So there's that. You got guys that have dominated the track in the past. Kurt Busch has been strong here. Matt Kenseth has won here numerous times. Carl Edwards is a three-time winner at Bristol. Tony Stewart, for all his tough luck so far this year and tough racing, runs pretty strong at Bristol. Denny Hamlin's won it. Joey Logano, the defending champ of the race. Keselowski's won. I mean, there's about 10 or 12 folks you can throw in a bucket and shake them up and say they've got a chance to win. Jimmy Johnson's won here. Junior obviously has won here. So it's going to be very, very good, I'm telling you. The Xfinity Series is going to be great. Got some of the Cup drivers going to be in that. Some of the guys pulling triple duty. I know Ryan Blaney is. We haven't been told the rest of the drivers going for all three races, but it's going to be a lot of good racing. You would want to get your tickets. Well, Tom, you're working over at the Speedway, and you're supposed to say all this. To a point. I will concede that. I proudly work for the Speedway, but just as a racing fan and a purist of the sport, as we talked yesterday, you can get tickets 300 laps for Friday race and the 500 lap Urban Tools night race starting at $100. Get tickets for both races. I mean, what do we figured out? Horace got on the mic, or on the microphone, got on the computer and figured out it was about 12 cents a lap for the last great Coliseum, the number one NASCAR race based on USA Today's Reader's Choice poll, and you're going to get it for $100. It's pretty good. Pretty good return on your investment for not one but two races. And so anyway, tickets are on sale, 423 Bristol, also BristolTix.com, and that's where you can call and get tickets or go to the website and get tickets, get ready to get after. It's going to be some great racing. The Food City 300 next Friday night, plus next Friday, Bass Pro Shop pole qualifying day for the Urban Tools night race. And then, of course, on Saturday, the big day with the Urban Tools night race. Back to defend his crown will be Joey Logano. Quick break. We'll be right back. Daniel Monjay due to join us from Milligan College. Big announcement about their baseball program. Pretty cool stuff, if I may say so myself. And so he'll join us coming up right after you hear this from our buddy Bays Mountain Park, Rob Cole, and Kim Smith, American Import and Auto Repair, and also our buddy Richard Isaacs from Kingsport Cabinetry. All straight ahead on this Thursday on the Tom Taylor Sports Show.
Hi, I'm Rob Cole with Bays Mountain Park. There's something for everyone at Bays Mountain Park. Whether you're an outdoor enthusiast or simply looking to get away and relax, Bays Mountain Park in Kingsport, Tennessee is the perfect destination. For only $4 per vehicle, enjoy 3,500 acres of breathtaking scenery featuring 40 miles of hiking trails, wildlife habitats, one of the Southeast's premier planetariums, and much, much more. For more information, please visit www.baysmountain.com or call us at 423-229-9447. Bays Mountain Park, one of the Tri-Cities' best places for learning, leisure, and recreation.
American Import and Auto Repair takes a lot of pride in their work and customer service. Owner Kim Smith tells us why someone should consider American Import and Auto Repair in Johnson City.
Well, of course, the first thing is you want to make sure that people are getting value for their dollar. Our emphasis is on quality, not quantity. We want to make sure that not only is the job being done, but it's done right with quality parts, with highly trained technicians. All of our technicians are ASE certified. We have several master techs, which is the highest you can get in the ASE. And ASE is a program that certifies people to the top level of their industry in car repair. We want people to feel comfortable. We never twist people's arms. Like I said, it's about quality. We want people to be happy. We want them to come back. We want a good name. You know, we're customers of other businesses. We wanted to be treated right, so we'd like to treat our customers right.
American Import and Auto Repair, Johnson City. Call today at 913-3111. Kingsport Cabinetry installs cabinets and countertops all over the three-state region. Owner Richard Isaac says there is no charge for his quotes.
All of our quotes and drawings are free. I know a lot of the national chains, big box stores and stuff, and I understand they have to charge a price to come out and measure and do a quote, but here at Kingsport Cabinetry, we do all that for free in hopes that our service is good enough. I always tell people this, Tom. I say, you can go anywhere in this town and get a product like I have, but find somebody you're comfortable working with. If you're not comfortable working with me, find somebody you are comfortable working with, but I can guarantee you we'll give you the service. We have a full shop back here that we do custom work, and I'll just move on a little bit. We get into commercial work. We do a lot of commercial work, a lot of healthcare, a lot of restaurants, banks, schools, things like that too.
Kingsport Cabinetry. Call Richard Isaacs today at 247-6134.
Back on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Thanks for being with us again on this Thursday. One ringy dingy.
Hello, this is Daniel.
There's Daniel Manjay from Milligan College. Good afternoon, sir. How you doing?
Good. I'm excellent.
Yes,
thanks
sir.
For having me on the show. It's good to be back. It's been a while.
He's back in the groove now. You went on vacation. You went to Oakland, and you sent me back a picture of the Coliseum, the home of the Raiders. That was pretty cool stuff. Did you enjoy your time in Oakland?
I did. It was a lot of fun. I actually was in San Francisco for the majority of the time, but shot over real quick, took the subway over to Oakland for an A's game while I was there, and that was a lot of fun. It was pretty cool to be in at that ballpark.
Now, the Coliseum, of course, we announced yesterday on the show that the Raiders have no place to go. The Oakland is not going to build them a new stadium. You were at the Coliseum. Is it pretty run down, or, I mean, is it kind of ancient or aged compared to other ballparks you've been to?
It definitely looks ancient. I wouldn't say run down, but it's definitely old. It's mostly concrete. I guess from what I was able to tell, you know, they've got, for baseball games, they've got the whole upper deck essentially kind of roped off because they put their big banner across the seats in the outfield. But from what I could tell, I mean, it still looks like it's in pretty good shape, just pretty old.
But it serves the point. I mean, so Oakland said the Raiders want a new stadium. Oakland says we're not going to build new stadiums. And now they're talking to San Antonio or talking to Los Angeles. So you've been there in the last month. Is it a stadium that cannot be used anymore? I mean, is it serving the purpose, or are they just the Raiders being greedy?
I don't know. I would say I think they can. Obviously, is that was it originally built for the Raiders?
No, it was originally built for the A's. They've split time with the A's and the Raiders, so the Raiders want their own place, like most NFL teams. But you know, I'm looking at it like this: I'd rather be there than looking for shopping for a new home, because you can't just build a stadium. It takes a couple of years to build one. So apparently, the Rose Bowl said they're not interested in having the Raiders or the Chargers or the Rams there, nor is the Coliseum. So I don't know where they're going to go. So
right, I guess the scary thought would be then that, you know, you'd worry about them moving somewhere.
Oh, I think it's a foregone conclusion. They're gone. I don't. The question is where. You know, back in the spring, we first started the show, San Antonio was showing some interest in having the Raiders move to San Antonio, Texas. So, anyway, you're at Oakland Coliseum. So, grading it from a 1 to 10, how would you grade Oakland Coliseum as a fan, as a spectator?
Well, I went into it. I think my expectations played a big part. I went into it from, you know, just meeting people out in San Francisco and talking to people, telling them that I was going to the game. A lot of people kind of didn't speak very highly of it and would kind of say, oh, yeah, you're going to one of the worst parks in the country.
Great.
So going into it with low expectations, I think, might have played a little bit, because my initial impression was, this is really not that bad. This is fine. There's nothing wrong with it. It's a little bit old, but overall, I mean, it's a nice park. And, you know, I don't know if I've shared this with you, but just one of my life goals being to go to each major league ballpark, or at least see each major league team at their home at their home field. That was not, I wouldn't put that as one of the worst stadiums that I've seen anyway.
Pretty cool. So how many have you been to so far?
I've been to 8. I've seen, I guess, of the 8 that I've been to, only St. Louis is. I went to Busch Stadium, but it wasn't actually for a game. It was for another event. I still count it, just because I don't know if I'll ever be able to get back out to St. Louis for a Cardinals game. But yeah, I've been to 8 total.
So which one was the dog? Obviously, Oakland's not the dog. Which one was the one that you were very unimpressed with?
I would probably say as much as. As much as I...
Just say it. Just say it.
Probably Wrigley, honestly. Wrigley. As much history is there, and with everything that they've just done historically, it's probably the most disappointing. Only, and this is going to... this is going to... My inner technology, need for technology is going to come out here, but just I think the lack of having a video board was big.
Yeah.
Being there, not really being able to see faces coming up on, you know, when people are coming up to bat, when people come in to pitch or whatever. Just having that to be able to see, and to be able to see replays and stuff like that, I think that was just a big part. And again, that's kind of a greedy thing to be complaining about. But
you're a fan, so. And on the flip side, out of fairness to you, what was the best ballpark you've been to so far out of the 8? Of course, there's a lot more to cover, but out of the 8 so far, which one wowed you? Which one did you like the best?
Well, as far as views, I would say PNC. Just having the – and when I went, I was in the behind home plate in the upper deck, so I had a fantastic view. I was able to see, you know, you've got the whole Pittsburgh skyline there. You've got the yellow bridges crossing the Allegheny River, I think it is. And then AT&T Park out in San Francisco is kind of the same way. If you're up in the upper deck behind home plate, you can see out, and you've got the, you know, the San Francisco Bay out there in the distance. So both of those were really cool, just from the view standpoint.
Talking to Daniel Monjay from Milligan College, which is not why we called him, but once it got going on, I thought it'd be pretty cool stuff to find out from a fan's. I mean, this guy's around sports all the time, so how was it for him as a spectator to go? And so he gave us a good rating of only 8 ballparks. He's got a lot more to cover, obviously, across the United States and all the different venues. All right, so we got big news coming out of Milligan College from the baseball team. Pretty exciting stuff. Tell me about it.
Yeah, definitely. Drew Bolin, we hired as our one of our new assistant baseball coaches. He is actually kind of a local guy a little bit. He's originally from Dandridge, Tennessee, and has spent the last 7 years in the minor league system for the San Francisco Giants. He was drafted in 2007, I think in the 23rd round by the Giants. and spent, like I said, 7 years there. During that 7 years, you know, the Giants won World Series titles and I guess three times in 2010, 12, and 14. Right before the 2014, the last one last year, the year before, I should say, he was he got his call up. Well, not his call up, but he moved up to AAA, and so was kind of right there, right kind of on that cusp. And from me talking to him, just some of the stuff that he's explained, you know, he was kind of developing, coming through their system at the same time as guys like Madison Bumgarner. I know Joe Panic, he said, is still a pretty good friend of his. So he knows a lot of names, a lot of the big names of guys that are just that he was there in the minor league system was developing.
Talking to Daniel Monjay, the sports information director at Milligan College. He joins us a couple of times. Well, he joins us every week, and Milligan's with us a couple of times a week. We had Mark Fox on earlier in the week, which is a great report from the athletic director. So I would think from a recruiting standpoint and just from a compliment standpoint, you tell somebody out there, don't want to wow you, but we got a former big league pitcher on our pitching coaching staff now at Milligan College. I would think that would really go kind of a wow factor. What do you think?
Yeah, I think so. And from, you know, the initial responses that we've gotten, you know, he came into the office this morning and was raving about how many of his friends and family had seen our release and had seen what we had posted on social media about it and just how much it had shared and just kind of been reached across. I would think, yeah, I mean, I think people are as excited as we are about it, and certainly that's going to help with recruiting, just knowing that they have that big name, that guy that has the experience, and not only the experience, but knowing that he was with a winning organization for that whole time is really cool.
Talking to Daniel Monjay, so his primary role, will he be teaching or coach? I know he's going to coaching, but is that all he's going to do? Is he going to be teaching on campus as well?
He'll be on campus. He was a pitcher, a right-hand pitcher, so he's going to be the primarily work with the pitcher. So he'll be, I guess, he's technically an assistant coach, but he'll be effectively the pitching coach. And then I'm sure he'll have other day-to-day stuff. We'll probably have a big role in recruiting as well. Just kind of, I guess, the normal assistant coach duties.
Neat stuff. Again, this is Milligan College. Also, you've been out and about watching some of the fall teams get ready. What's the latest on the volleyball and the soccer teams?
Yeah, they're actually probably about done with their preseason training. I think most of them will be done either tomorrow or at some point over the weekend because we've got school starting next week. But I've been out. My untrained, non-coaching experience eye has gone out and seen each one, taken some pictures. Everybody looks good from what I've been able to tell. The only coach that I've really been able to talk to about some details was Don Eva, our volleyball coach. She's really excited about the season. She's been really impressed with their preseason. The ladies were finished third in the conference last year, and they were projected third in the preseason poll this year. So I think that's kind of a motivational factor for them, knowing that, you know, they're going to be one of the best teams in the conference. And Don Eva was even talking to me earlier about how she doesn't think she's just from the hard work that she's seen from her players so far, that she doesn't really feel like there's anybody else in the conference that would be working harder than they are at this point. So I think we've got a lot of really cool, really good stuff to look forward to for them this year.
Well put. So we got soccer and volleyball getting geared up, and of course a new baseball coach, a pitching coach coming from the bigs, now on the staff of Milligan College. Is he there effective immediately?
Yes, he's been around. He was actually in here. We were going through some information with him a few minutes ago about just getting some recruits put up on the web and everything for them. So hopefully in the next couple of days, maybe by next week at the latest, we'd have a release up on our website with all the information about the new baseball class, everybody coming in to play baseball.
Absolutely. Of course, we want to get him on the Tom Diller Sports Show whenever you can work that out. I'd love to have him on for a few minutes in the future. So, good stuff. Again, this young man's name, if you missed it earlier, his name is?
I'm sorry, I missed the question.
I said his name is?
Oh, Drew Boland.
Drew Boland, there you go. Drew Boland, pitch for the Giants, is that correct?
Yes, San Francisco Giants. Drafted in 2007 in the 23rd round, played about 7 years in the minors. And now it's here at Milligan College, and we're excited to have him.
There you go. Very good. Good job. Hey, appreciate you again one more time, as always. Where can we go find out more on the website about Milligan College sports?
MilliganBuffs.com.
Last question, being in Oakland Coliseum for an A's game, did you see anything out there about the Raiders or any signs or any get your Raiders tickets? Or was it all, it was an Oakland A's baseball game. Was there any crossover promotion of my greatest, the greatest football team ever?
Well, when within the ballpark, no, I didn't see any. I wasn't really looking.
Thanks. Okay.
I didn't mean it like that. I meant just, you know, you're there. Just I was there for as much just what was around the ballpark and just the whole outside atmosphere as much as anything.
Gotcha.
But there is, you know, when you come in, when you walk, if you come from the subway, which is where I came from, you come down that walkway and then on that first concourse before you go in, you know, they've got the big draped banners on the front of the Coliseum there. That's, you know, they got one for the A's and then there's one for the Raiders too.
There you go, my boys. Tomorrow night.
I got my picture in front of that too.
Did you really?
I'll send you that one too.
Yeah, I like to see that in front of that big old banner. That's great. Good stuff. Daniel, my friend, as always, thank you. We'll talk to some more Milligan folks next week. Keep on keeping on, and I'll talk to you then. Thanks for the thanks for the update. All right.
Yeah, thank you. We appreciate it.
Yep, great.
Talk to you later.
Yes, sir. Great job again. Daniel Monjay from Milligan College. That's pretty cool. Went to the Oakland Coliseum, enjoyed the A's game, and, you know, he brought up a good question. I don't know that. When I started following the Raiders, I was a little guy, so I don't know whether they built the Coliseum specifically for the A's or for the Raiders, or it was to be joined, used in a joint joint capacity, which they are, obviously. And you can tell where the Raiders play. You can see where they use the football or the baseball field to reconfigure to make it a football field for the Raiders games. But anyway, Oakland, no viable proposal was the words we were told yesterday by the Oakland City folks. And so the Raiders are shopping for a new home. Could be L.A., could be San Antonio. I guess, crazy enough, it could always go to some place where they've left. You know, the Rams left St. Louis. Maybe Mark Davis will go back into St. Louis and build a stadium. Who knows? With the Raiders, you just never know. But again, thanks to Monjay. Pretty cool stuff. Again, a former big pitcher, now a minor league pitcher as well. Now the pitching coach at Milligan College and Coach Boland, and that's good stuff. We'll try and get him on the show with Monjay's help in the not-too-distant future. Tom Taylor Sports Show coming up on 2 weeks from Friday night, 2 weeks tomorrow night, our first Science Hill football game. Cannot wait. We're going to unveil our broadcast team for you. We're still putting those pieces in place, to be perfectly honest with you. But we've had some folks interested in being part of the Science Hill broadcast team, and we're going to do that coming up here very soon. The first game is 2 weeks tomorrow night. Very excited about some of our sponsors that have jumped on board, and we're tickled to death. We really are. And so it's going to be good. Science Hill playing, as we said, tomorrow night, a scrimmage down in Knoxville against Knox Catholic, which is a very, very good football team. One of their offensive linemen, I think it's offensive lineman, Coach Carter told me, one of the top prospects in the country. And so this is a typically a very good football program. They have the ability, being a private school, to go out and get who they want. And more times than not, they do. And so Knox Catholic's a pretty good football team. It'll be a good test tomorrow night for the Hilltoppers, who have added some personnel. Had a couple of transfers come in. We'll tell you about that tomorrow, that have come in from other schools and have really bolstered, if that's the right word, the football team at Science Hill. They've got some pretty good players that have moved into the Science Hill district and can now become eligible immediately for Science Hill football, and they are. University of Michigan, what do you think about this? They have banned selfie sticks in the football games at all home games in Michigan State in the Big House in Ann Arbor. The mention of selfie sticks is to be clear to the public. The sticks are included in the traditional can't bring them in. Flagpoles, tripods, projectiles, and now selfie sticks are no-no. Michigan made this decision in the interest of public safety, but the school doesn't need any elaborate explanation to convince the update to its stadium code of conduct. Selfie sticks banned at Michigan. Also, the school has banned drones from flying over the stadium during games, which is, I find interesting. I saw a gentleman flying some drones over the Crazy Eights Road Race last month in Kingsport. That is becoming something of the future, but apparently not in Michigan. They're banning selfie sticks and drones flying over the stadium during games at all Michigan home football games at the Big House in Ann Arbor. And speaking of Michigan, also a story coming out of Ann Arbor today. For the Michigan Wolverines, their Facebook pages have been hacked. I don't know how you do that. I'm not up on that. But sometime late Monday night, early Tuesday morning, someone got a hold of the Michigan Athletic Facebook pages. And, of course, I'm sure, I don't know what was on there, but there's some things that didn't go well. I'm sure some folks took exception and said some things. Here's one. Here's a picture. Wow. Here's one. If you're a fan of tattooed moms, for instance, this is what you want when you start following Michigan football. It's a picture of tattooed moms are beautiful. This has since been taken down, but that was on there. Somebody tapped into it and hacked it. Or here's one. You want to feel better about your own tan lines by giggling at other people's. We've all had bad tan burn lines. Feel better laughing those who didn't. And so there's pictures of that. So, yeah, somebody's hacked into it. Here's one that got on there. 26 stars and weren't wearing any underwear on the red carpet. That's all been since taken down. So somebody's hacked into the Michigan football. even a picture of Urban Meyer got onto the Michigan football Facebook. So anyway, that's been quickly fixed and taken care of. But again, that's what got into it on Monday night. And so tattooed moms are beautiful, bad tan lines on people, and also 26 stars not wearing any bloomers on the red carpet and award shows. That's what got hacked into the Michigan football Facebook. And of course, that's got fixed quickly, obviously, by the folks that do those kind of things at the University of Michigan. But somebody somewhere were eating pizza and high-fiving each other because they pulled it off. Tom Taylor Sports Show again coming up. We'll check in with Tim Smith, American Import and Auto Repair, later in the show. We'll check in with Carmichael, see what's going on in his mind, the John City Parks and Rec, our weekly visit with him. Also, Jim Klein joins a little bit later in the show here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. How about this? You got guys staying in dorms. Staying in dorms. This is Pat Narduzzi. Hope I'm saying it right. Staying with his team in the dorms for the Pitt training camp. First-year coach Pat Narduzzi has been on the job in Pittsburgh for a while now, but fall camp will give him a unique opportunity to better know his players. He'll be spending fall camp with the team in the dorm. While previous Pitt camps have involved players getting to stay in their own homes, he has all 105 players together in the same building. Quote, I'm staying around them in the dorm to get to know them more, see how they live, see what type of music they're listening to in the evenings, what they're eating, those types of things. Our kids, they feel great with one another. They love each other and have that relationship. And the coaches love the players. The players love the coaches. We're going to win some football games because we like each other. Other assistant coaches joining him in the dorms are on a rotation. But the former Michigan State defensive coordinator plans to spend the entirety of camp roughing it with the rest of the team. So they're rotating the assistants, but the head man is there for the whole training camp, living in the dorm with his players. I think that's pretty cool. And I would think that would cut down. Case in point, when you drive by neighborhoods and you see a law enforcement officer living in that neighborhood and their car, cruiser, is parked out in their front, be it a city, county, or THP, one would go, this is probably not a neighborhood I want to do something really dumb in because there sits a cruiser, which means a law enforcement officer lives in our neighborhood. Same here. Better not do something really stupid. Coach is not across town with his family. Coach is upstairs on the second floor or whatever. Living with us. So I would think that would deter chances to be mischievous or do pranks or otherwise if you're a Pitt, University of Pittsburgh football player with the coach staying with you in the dorm during training camp. Tom Taylor Sports Show again. Thanks for being with us. Tim Smith joins us coming up. First, would you please welcome a young lady from Kingsport, Tennessee. Love to hear her sing. You get more and more comments about this all the time. Taylor Gee Sanders from Kingsport, now from Nashville, singing our national anthem.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleam? Broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous
That right there is strong right there. I'm telling you, that is good, good stuff. Thank you again, Taylor Geese Sanders from Nashville, formerly Kingsport, singing the national anthem here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Quick break. We'll be right back. Tim Smith joins us. Before we go to the break, again, updating what we told you at the outset of the show, a couple of college football stars out. Michigan State linebacker Ed Davis blows out a knee, out for the season. Clemson, Clemson defensive back Corn Wiggins, torn ACL, out for the season. And so a couple of big names. And, of course, we told you Jackson, the big offensive lineman for the Tennessee Volunteers, but appears to be out for the season as well. Certainly out for a while anyway. And, again, my guess is he has gone for the year. So, anyway, we appreciate that update, what's going on in the world of sports here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Steve Spurrier, as we told you earlier, before we go to the break here and check in with Tim Smith, Steve Spurrier bringing back his best material to the media this season. And Spurrier, again, mocked the rosy, positive tone of coaches' comments in the preseason with a bit of sarcasm. He says, quote, "I'll tell you what, we had another sorry practice today. These guys, I don't know if we're going to be able to beat anybody this year. Quarterback, they can't hit the broadside of a barn right now. I don't know if we can hit the side of that practice facility right there. The receivers, I don't think they'd catch a cold if it was in the middle of February, dropping everything. Defensive backs, gosh, no wonder they've got grass stain all their jerseys. They're falling down about every play. Kickers, gee, it's like the Army. Left, right, they're kicking all over the place. I don't know if we'll beat anybody this year. Leadership, we don't have any leaders out there. Guys are soft or sissies. Maybe I ought to give them the week off, see if we can reboot and find some real tough guys out there." And so then he cracks a big smile and says, "Gotcha." So good stuff. Steve Spurrier, big fan. As I told you earlier in the show, huge supporter of high school athletics here in the Tri-City, specifically Science Hill. And he's all about taking care of his alma mater. And he has the financial resources to do that, obviously. And he has been. And, again, that's kudos to Steve Spurrier. That's nice to give back. He has not forgot. What's the old saying? Don't forget. Don't get above your raisins, what Granddad used to say. And he has not got above his raisins. He has not forgot where he came from. And that's good stuff. And we appreciate him very much. Quick break. We'll be right back. We'll check in with our buddy Tim Smith, see what's going on there. Again, with our buddy Tim on the Tom Taylor Sports Show, again on this Thursday. Again, ready to go next week for Bristol Live. Can't wait. It's going to be a lot of fun, and we'll do that again next week, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. We'll park this show and be up the track doing Bristol Live, again, across four radio stations. It's going to be now broadcast across property in the guest services booths, also the guest welcome village. Kids Zone is going to be all across property. You're going to hear us a lot on the Bristol Live program, brought to you by Yates Nationwide Agency, also by Food City, also by Chick-fil-A and the Crossings in North Johnson City. We're very excited about that. And some other great sponsors like Bracken Paving and Asphalt Maintenance, also American Import and Auto Repair, Blue Lizard, the Australian Sun Cream, Jolly Good, Blue Lizard. It's terrible. Not even close to doing an English accent. Anyway, Blue Lizard's with us on the Bristol Live show. And that is exciting news. Appreciate the folks over there, Crown Laboratories, coming on board with us. Quick break. We'll be right back. Tim Smith joins us coming up next on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Huh. Well, we're supposed to hit that button right there.
At Bristol Orthotics and Prosthetics, they treat thousands of patients each year dealing with diabetes and its effects. Diabetes overtaking our nation and leaving a path of destruction behind. Through wound care, office visits, and preventive care, they see most of the patients after a problem arises. Using diabetic footwear, such as shoes and inserts, a great way to prevent or prolong skin breakdown and amputation. At Bristol Orthotics and Prosthetics, they use only custom molds from patient mold inserts, which further ensure a great recovery, or better yet, prevents a wound from happening. They use custom molded shoes, bracing, custom inserts, and extra depth diabetic shoes to prevent wounds or other skin issues from beginning. Call today, 1-800-524-4447. 39 years, 6 locations, 1 family. Bristol Orthotics and Prosthetics, 1-800-524-4447.
American Import and Auto Repair takes a lot of pride in their work and customer service. Owner Kim Smith tells us why someone should consider American Import and Auto Repair in Johnson City.
Well, of course, the first thing is you want to make sure that people are getting value for their dollar. Our emphasis is on quality, not quantity. We want to make sure that not only is the job being done, but it's done right with quality parts, with highly trained technicians. All of our technicians are ASE certified. We have several master techs, which is the highest you can get in the ASE. And ASE is a program that certifies people to the top level of their industry in car repair. We want people to feel comfortable. We never twist people's arms. Like I said, it's about quality. We want people to be happy. We want them to come back. We want a good name. You know, we're customers of other businesses. We want to be treated right, so we'd like to treat our customers right.
American Import and Auto Repair, Johnson City. Call today at 913-3111. Kingsport Cabinetry installs cabinets and countertops all over the three-state region. I ask owner Richard Isaacs, is there a template or is the sky the limit?
Pretty much the sky's the limit. We have a very good drawing system that you come in, tell me what you want. If you have a set of house plans that you're working with, you're building a new house, we can take it off the house plans, we can draw it up, do you 3D drawings where you can see exactly where all the doors, the drawers, the color of the cabinets, kind of get close to the color of the countertops in your drawings, go over that with you, then you can say, well, Richard, let's change this. I'd rather for that door to open the other way, or I want that cabinet to be bigger, that cabinet to be smaller. We can customize it to your needs. You know, it's all about what the customer wants. We want them to be happy when they leave here.
Kingsport Cabinetry. Call Richard Isaacs today at 247-6134.
Back on the Tom Toto Sports Show, got some breaking news from Ohio State. Former Ohio State coach Earl Bruce recovering from a stroke suffered earlier this month. Again, 84 years old, rehabbing at Dodd Hall at Ohio State. And so, again, Earl Bruce, former coach of the Ohio State Buckeyes, recovering from a stroke, and that's what's going on. We just got that from Ohio State. All right, let's see what's going on here. Let's go to the phone. Let's see if we can't get a man on. There we go. Let's see if we can get him on and talk a little American Import and Auto Repair here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. All right, there's one ringy-dingy. By the way, hello to Donnie Paul, Cherokee Barbershop. Hello, Donnie. It's Elvis. Two ringy-dingies. Three ringy dingies. Four ringy dingies. Five ringy dingies. Six ringy dingies.
I'm sorry, the person you were trying to reach has a voice.
All right, so... Oh, I just got this. All right. Let me just go ahead and send him this message, because he's not... All right. There we go. Let's get that caught up to date, so we'll try it again here in just a second. NFL preseason football game tonight. We told you earlier who's playing where. Saints will be in Baltimore. New England against Green Bay. That'll be... Should be a good one. How many reps will Aaron Rodgers take for the Packers? And, of course, Tom Brady for the Patriots remains to be seen. I wouldn't think a whole lot. They're playing tonight in Foxborough. Jets at Detroit. The Bears at Soldier Field. Again, hosting the Miami Dolphins. Washington at Cleveland. Battle of the Browns. Johnny Manziel, how many snaps will he be taking? Is he the quarterback of the future for the Browns? I don't think so. I've said that from the get-go. I don't think he's got it. Don't think he's an NFL quarterback day in and day out. But we'll see. What do I know? I'm sitting here in East Tennessee, but that's my opinion. Dallas, the Cowboys, Jason Witten, the boys, will be in San Diego tonight to battle the Chargers. All that's on Thursday tonight. Tomorrow, Carolina at Buffalo. The Titans will be in Atlanta to battle the Falcons. Steelers in Jacksonville tomorrow night. Cincinnati hosting the New York Giants and Eli Manning. Denver, Peyton and the boys will be in Seattle tomorrow night. And, of course, the real game, the only game, as far as I'm concerned,
the Raiders.
We'll be at home against the St. Louis Rams tomorrow night at a 10 o'clock kickoff in the Coliseum. Saturday, NFL preseason football, Minnesota hosting Tampa Bay, 49ers in Houston, Kansas City at Arizona. And then on Sunday afternoon, the Colts will play in Philadelphia against the Philadelphia Phillies. Let's try him again. See what's going on, my man here. There we go. Tom Taylor Sports Show again on this Thursday afternoon. One ringy dingy. There we go. Two ringy dingies. All right. Three ringy dingies. You guessed it. Four ringy dingies.
I'm sorry, the person.
All right, he must be detained. He must be working with a customer because that's normally what happens. We can't get him because he's normally spot on. So, three biggest names in golf, getting an idea of how Whistling Straits will play during the opening round of the PGA Championship. Rory McIlroy, Jordan Spieth, and Zach Johnson await their afternoon tee time at 2:20. Meanwhile, players are carving birdies out of the rolling terrain near in Wisconsin. Early leaders, Robert Streb, Ryan Moore, Paul Casey, 3 under par. That was about 10 o'clock this morning. 28 golfers under par in the morning's competition. And let's see, Dustin Johnson through 10. Denmark's Thomas Bjorn through 14. Tiger Woods started on the back nine. Bogey, the number 14, made the turn at 1 over. And so that's what's going on right now. At the top of the leaderboard, of course, that's very, very early in the PGA Championship. Dustin Johnson from the USA, Thomas Bjorn from Denmark, also Jason Day, Harris English, Matt Jones, Russell Henley, Robert Streb, James Morrison, Paul Casey, some of Ricky Fowler, some of the folks. 13th currently Rory Sabatini, Sergio Garcia currently tied for 13th, 2 under. So those are some of the numbers right now at the PGA Championship in Wisconsin. So I just want to keep you up to speed on that again on this Thursday. All right, let's see. And he said he picked up, but, All right, maybe, did I do something wrong? Let's see here. It's live on the internet. This is where we are. So try again, all right? Let's try it again. All right, let's see if this is it. See if this will go. One ringy-dingy. Two ringy-dingy, three to ringy-dingy, and four to ringy-dingy.
I'm sorry, the person you were trying to reach has a voicemail box that has not...
All right, so must have issues with the old phone system. That's a shocker. So anyway, that's what's going on. We'll try and hook back up with him in a little while. Here, our buddy Tim Smith, American Import and Auto Repair. Let's see what else going on in sports again on this Thursday. Want to bring you up to speed in baseball news. Blue Jays, Dave Dombrowski, who got let go by the Detroit Tigers last week or week before last, being reported to being courted by the Toronto Blue Jays. Former Tiger president and GM Dave Dombrowski might not be out of work for long. He was fired August the 4th by Detroit. He's been contacted by the Toronto Blue Jays about becoming president of their team. So we'll have to see if that'll shake out and actually come to fruition. Dombrowski, 27 years experience as a baseball executive, including serving as the GM for the Expos, the Marlins, and Detroit. GM of the Marlins when the team got their first World Series title back in 97. The Tigers have advanced to the postseason of each of the last four seasons under his guidance, but he got let go for whatever reason. And so Jays president Paul Beeston, who is 70, will retire at the end of the season. And so we'll see what happens if he, in fact, gets hired by the Toronto Blue Jays. So, anyway, the courtship of Dombrowski shows the fact this guy knows what he's doing, obviously. So he has won in Montreal, the Marlins, and Detroit, GM of the Marlins for the first World Series back in 1997, and Detroit's advanced to the postseason each of the last four seasons under his guidance, but he's no longer there. And so Toronto says, if you don't want him, we'll take him. So That's where we are right now. Tom Taylor Sports Show. Again, quick break. We'll be right back. We'll see if we can track down my man, see where he's at. That would be our buddy Tim Smith from American Import and Auto Repair right here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show.
At Bristol Orthotics and Prosthetics, they treat thousands of patients each year dealing with diabetes and its effects. Diabetes overtaking our nation and leaving a path of destruction behind. Through wound care, office visits, and preventive care, they see most of the patients after a problem arises. Using diabetic footwear, such as shoes and inserts, a great way to prevent or prolong skin breakdown and amputation. At Bristol Orthotics and Prosthetics, they use only custom molds from patient mold inserts, which further ensure a great recovery, or better yet, prevents a wound from happening. They use custom molded shoes, bracing, custom inserts, and extra depth diabetic shoes to prevent wounds or other skin issues from beginning. Call today, 1-800-524-4447. 39 years, 6 locations, 1 family. Bristol Orthotics and Prosthetics, 1-800-524-4447.
It's Friday night at 7 o'clock. You've been involved in a car accident. You may be out of state on vacation or just a few miles from home. What do? Who do you call? At Farmers Insurance Group, one call is all you have to make. Hello, this is Jim Klein, an agent with Farmers Insurance. It's called One and Done. You don't have to wait till Monday morning to file a claim. You can make the initial call, and we begin right away to help you. We assist you in moving the vehicle to a certified repair shop, getting you set up with rental car, and informing your agent. Then here at the staff at Jim Klein Farmers Insurance, we follow the claim through to the end. It's that easy. One and Done. We're your one and done location for all your insurance needs. Auto, home, life, commercial, workers' comp, and bonds. We can help you with all your insurance needs. Give me a call today, Jim Klein, Jim Klein Farmers Insurance at 247-5400, your one-and-done location in Kingsport, 247-5400.
From the driveways where your kids play basketball and ride their bicycles, to the parking lots at your local church or grocery store, Bracken Paving is an important part of many neighborhoods in our area. No matter how large or how small the job, Bracken strives for excellence in every service they provide. It's a foundation for a strong community. Discover the difference at Bracken Paving and Asphalt Maintenance. Give us a call or visit us online at brackenpaving.com.
Your life is always changing. You never know what shape it will take or how your financial needs might change. But if we talk about your investments and how they can provide for you and your family, the future becomes clear. At Wells Fargo Advisors, we believe conversation leads to financial clarity. Let's start a conversation today.
There he is. Amazing. I got the right buttons hooked in. There we go. Our buddy Tim Smith, American Import and Auto Repair, joining us again here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show again on this Thursday afternoon. How are you, sir?
Good. How are you?
Well, I can't complain. Wasn't doing good, so I want to check in with you and see how everything's going. And what's happening in your world right now? Is it busy down at American Import and Auto Repair?
Yes, we're fairly busy, so things are good.
You have been blessed. You're exactly right. So tell me, what do we need to know right now about our cars, our vehicles, again, here in the late summer?
Well, right now, just make sure that, forget weather-wise, just maintenance-wise, time to belt the water pump and things like that are important. If you haven't had yours done in a while, usually the interval is anywhere from 60,000 to 100,000 miles is when that needs to happen. And if your AC has gotten charged at the beginning of the year and starting beginning of the summer, starting to get a little bit warm, it might be a time to look at it and see if there's a leak or see if there's an issue.
So can you run, can AC go down in one season with usage?
If it has a small leak, yes. If it has a big leak, it'll go in a week or less. But a very small leak, it can just leak out over the season. Some people don't want to get it fixed, so they'll just every year they'll just get it redone, and we'll put more in there, and that's how they do it. So we can do it either way.
Talking to Tim Smith, American Import and Auto Repair, home of the free loaner car program. I was down there earlier today. We were talking about water pumps. That's something a lot of folks don't think about in the vehicle, yet it's a critical part. Tell me about water pumps.
Water pumps are very important, and even some of the imports are actually using plastic on the water pumps. So there could be an issue with that. With the timing belt, they're usually replaced
with it as well, and in one package at between 60, like I said earlier, between 60 and 100,000 miles.
Neat stuff. And so what are some, I know this is going to be a goofy question, what are some red flags that your water pump is going bad? I mean, if it goes real bad, we know, but what are some of the signs it may be going bad?
Well, if it's there's a little weep hole in the bottom, and if it starts to go bad, you'll see just a little bit of a leak on the water pump, and that is where they leak from. Also, if your car's starting to get a little warmer than it used to, you know, the thermostat, you know, could be a thermostat, could be a water pump or things like that. So, and when you do a timing belt, you automatically do that with it. So if it's time for a timing belt, it's probably close to time for a water pump.
Talking to Tim Smith, American Import and Auto Repair, home of the Free Loader Car Program, located between Johnson City and Jonesboro there on 11E. And, again, import and auto repair, domestic and import. What are some of the jobs you guys are working on down there today?
Well, actually, we have a BW that needs a timing belt water pump, and we're doing that. We have a Chevy van that's here that's getting some AC work done. We have a Nissan here that's getting evaporative stuff done for the emissions control. So we're doing quite a variety of things, and we have another one or two here for brakes.
So a little bit of everything. Of course, that's the way it is. No job's ever the same, no two jobs, which is what really makes your job kind of interesting, because there's something always going on, and it's always something different, right?
There, you know, with so many different vehicles, it's always exciting.
Let's talk about the electrical. We never talk much about that. Fuses and headlights and electrical problems. You guys take care of those. Typically, what kind of electrical problems would someone come in with?
I'd say that their rear brake lights don't work. That could be something as simple as a brake light bulb, or it could be in the wiring, or it could be in some of the sensors going up to the front. So you never know what you're getting into when you have an electrical issue. We have one guy that loves doing that. That's what he really likes to do, and he is very good at it. So we can track down just about any electrical issue with your car and fix it.
Hate to use that dreaded word winter, but it's not that far away, unfortunately. We're inside of 135 days till Christmas, so you know winter and cold weather's not that far away. So is there anything we need to be doing now here in August to get ready for the cooler temperatures and colder weather around the corner?
Well, I would check your tires, making sure they're good for the winter. So, you know, we've had some bad winters lately. If your tires are bald, it doesn't matter what brand you have. So it's important to check them, and they're actually having some sales on Michelin's and BF Goodrich coming up here in a couple weeks. So I would plan and budget for that.
Talking to Tim Smith, American Import and Auto Repair, one of our great sponsors. He'll be with us next week on Bristol Live. We'll be up the track Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, talking all about the great things going on at American Import and Auto Repair, and certainly Bristol Motor Speedway. A lot of them out there. What do you feel like separates you from the competition?
We have loaner cars. We have four ASE Master Techs. We are a ASE Blue Seal shop. We are Bosch certified. We're a Bosch Car Care Center. We keep up with all the newest stuff coming out. We send our guys to lots of schools, and we just keep up with the technology.
It's just that simple, and of course they do a great job. Also, the mechanics back there, we talk about this all the time. Some have none, some may have one. You've got what, four now, is that correct?
Four ASE Master Techs, yes.
That is awesome. Who might those folks be?
That would be Greg Lawson.
Greg Lawson.
That would be Jake Vance, Brent Smith, and Tim Smith.
There you go. So four of them. So also, if you need basic things done, like an oil change, they can get you in, get you out. That's where I get my oil change. They do a great job. And so I'm in there, I don't know, maybe 10, 15 minutes tops, and I'm out. Every time I get my oil change, like I got one coming up. So you do that, but you can also do everything up to a total engine replacement, right?
Yes, we can. You know, if you need a headlight changed or something very simple like that, we do that as well. On our oil changes, we also check your battery, which most places don't do. So we'll be happy to check that and give you a printout and tell you if your battery is good or if it's going to give you actual problems in the next while, so you can budget for that as well.
There you go. It's all again on 11E between Johnson City and Jonesboro. What are the hours you're open at American Import and Auto Repair?
8 to 5, Monday through Friday, and 8 to 12, Saturday.
You've been open on Saturday. And I want to squeeze in, too, because this is very important. You and Kim, of course, it's husband-wife team that owns the business. You folks really like to help out females. I know a lot of times females sometimes get kind of a raw deal. That's just the way it is, whether you want to admit it or not, but it's true. Going to other places, they don't get a fair shake or kind of get hoodooed, if you will. There, you have kind of a warm spot for the females, be the divorcees or single or widows. That's just what it is, right?
That is our target audience. We want to help, and we want to be a part of the solution.
There you go. And so you can give them a call, 913-3111. Tim, great job, my friend. Thank you for checking in with us. Water pumps, oil changes, electrical work, timing belts. I mean, you name it, they can do it for you. Again, at American Import and Auto Repair. Get home with a free loaner car program, 913-3111. Great report, my friend. Keep smiling, and I'll talk to you soon, all right?
Thanks, Tom.
All right, great job. Yep, that's my buddy Tim Smith right there. He does a super job, and I appreciate him very much. Well, we got modern technology working over on the right. I love it. I have no clue why it's doing what it's doing, but it's saying it's shutting down and restarting. It's sitting there spinning, so the pooter is temporarily on the skids, which is okay because I'm on a live sports show, and so it is what it is, but I will just work our way through it, work around it, and keep on keeping on as best I can tell you. Tom Taylor Sports Show. Again, want to talk to you for just a second about what you can get involved in at Speedway Children's Charities. Again, coming up at the track next week, all kinds of different options. We talked with Claudia earlier in the week, Claudia Bird from Speedway Children's Charities, the different options you can get involved in. It's a golf tournament. Of course, they're selling donuts up there on property. Let's see, what else? I had them right here, and I dropped them in my quest to fix the camera earlier. I have to find them again. We had everything written down and right where I needed it to be, and it all just kind of went crazy, but hang on. We'll look and we'll find it. Maybe I won't. Oh, there it is. Fell on the floor. All right. There we go. All right. Fell off the table into the floor. Golf tournament coming up on Monday for Speedway Children's Charities. Also, the Shooter's Edge golf tournament, or not golf tournament, but shooting tournament at Shooter's Edge. That'll be on the 18th, which will be, what, next 18th will be next Tuesday. Shooter's Edge. You can go to the website, speedwaycharities.org, and click on Bristol, and you can find out more about that. Also going on now, the Ultimate Experiences and also the Ride of a Lifetime. What a cool event for you to Ride of a Lifetime around the High Banks of Bristol next week. And so you can go on there and bid on that. It's a bidding process, and the highest bidder gets to ride with your favorite driver in the pickup. The pickup bid as they drive around the track during driver intros. Cornhole Tournament. Have you ever done this? I tried my hand at that not too long ago. Not real good. Had fun at it, but not real good at it. Cornhole tournament takes a lot of skills, kind of horseshoes with bean bags for all intents and purposes. They're having a cornhole tournament, Flex Seal Cornhole Tournament coming up next weekend on the grounds of Bristol Motor Speedway with a lot of cool prizes, all to help Speedway Children's Charities. As we said, when you're up there next week, Krispy Kreme donuts being sold where you can make a purchase there on the property. And when you buy the donuts there at Bristol Motor Speedway, a portion of that will go to Speedway Children's Charities, and all that money stays here in the region. These kids, $749,000 they raised last year, and all that money stayed right here in Northeast Tennessee and Southwest Virginia for the young people. Johnsonville Bronsonby being sold up there next week, and part of that will go to Speedway Children's Charities. Also, the 5K road race a week from tonight there on the grounds at Bristol Motor Speedway if you're a runner. I think Wineman City ran it one time. If you're a runner, that'd be one you want to go to. Also, a week from tonight is the memorabilia auction, which is really cool. On the third floor of the Bruton Smith building. Very, very nice evening and great job. And you can have a big time up there and come out of there with some interesting things. Folks buying lug nuts and tires and fenders and hoods and, oh gosh, you name it. Coming off of a vehicle, you can get it at the memorabilia auction at Speedway Children's Charities. And that'll be coming up again Thursday night, a week from tonight, on the third floor of the Bruton Smith building at Bristol Motor Speedway. And it's all about the kids. All these events are fundraisers for Speedway Children's Charities. All that money stays here in the region. And last year, with all the different fundraising activities and efforts, they raised $749,000 for that money to stay right here in the region. Imagine if the kids take that out of the economy, take that out of the equation, a $749,000 deficit. Be a lot of kids, a lot of programs just couldn't keep going because just wouldn't have the financial resources to make that happen. So good thing to get involved in, whether it's golf, cornhole tournament, again, the shooting tournament at Shooter's Edge in Piney Flats, the cornhole tournament, as we said, Krispy Kreme donuts, you name it, it's going to be there. And we would encourage you to please consider taking some of that in or all that in next week. Again, go to speedwaycharities.org and, again, hit the tab Bristol. I'll give you all that information you need to know. Daniel Norris last night, Johnson City Science Hill native, had that start for the Detroit Tigers. The more I look at that, the numbers, they're not great, but they're not bad. 6 1/3 innings, 6 hits, 4 runs, 3 of those earned. He walked 3 and struck out 2. He being Daniel Norris, again from Science Hill, Johnson City, or Johnson City Science Hill High School. Now with the Detroit Tigers, his third start, did real good in Baltimore, got lit up against Boston at home last week, and now his third start in Kansas City. It was a no decision, but again, not bad. 6 1/3, 6 hits, that's a hit an inning, obviously. 4 runs, 3 of those earned. He walked 3 and struck out 2. So could have been better, but could have been worse. And so he'll sit back and do another 5 days, which will be Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. Usually Monday or Tuesday of next week, he'll be ready to go with a brand-new pitching assignment for the Detroit Tigers of the American League. So hope he continues to do well, and I hope he, again, keeps on keeping on and stays up there in the bigs. I hate to see him go back down to the AAA again. I would think going up and down like a yo-yo would kind of, I would think, mess with your psyche to a point. If you're there and then back down and you're there and back down, I would think that would be tough to do. So we want him to stay up there and do well because he represents all of us here in Northeast Tennessee. NASCAR Sprint Cup Series, the Pure Michigan 400 coming up. Practice starts tomorrow. Qualifying will be tomorrow afternoon, again, at Michigan International Speedway. Jeff Gordon last year raced to the third of his 4 2014 victories. So he is he's going to be the man to be sought after up there again coming up, as we said, this weekend. Jimmy Johnson tied with Busch for the series victory lead with 4. Kyle Busch has won 4 of the last 7 races. And again, defending series champion Kevin Harvick leads the standings, 42 points ahead of Logano. And so that'll be, again, this weekend, the Michigan, Pure Michigan 400. Again, the defending champ of the race, Jeff Gordon. The Xfinity Series, the Nationwide Children's Hospital 200 in Lexington, Ohio. The winner from a year ago is Chris Buescher, raced to his first series victory at that race. That'll be coming up again. Pole qualifying will be on Saturday afternoon. The race itself will be Saturday evening. And so that'll be, again, the Xfinity Series, Nationwide Children's Hospital 200. Again, last year, Chris Buescher won that race. And also you have Buescher leading the standings, 24 points ahead of the defending champ Chase Elliott and Ty Dillon. Also, the Camping World Truck Series racing in Michigan will stay with the Cups this week. And again, practice tomorrow, pole qualifying on Saturday, racing on Saturday afternoon, pole qualifying on Saturday morning. Johnny Sauter held off the Thor Sport teammate Matt Crafton to win that race last year. So the Camping World Truck Series Careers for Veterans 200. And so all three of those in action this week. Michigan for the Cup and for the truck, and Lexington, Ohio for the Xfinity Series and the Nationwide Children's Hospital 200. Quick break. We'll be back with more here again on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Again on this, on this Thursday, August the 13th, 2015. Come back with us. Got a story of brewing about some action going on in the National Football League. You want to hear all about that right after this, again on the Tom Taylor Sports Show, again on this Thursday, August the 13th.
Kingsport Cabinetry installs cabinets and countertops all over the three-state region. Owner Richard Isaac says they work with both commercial and residential customers and love to help remodel existing homes.
What we do is if somebody comes in and wants to do a remodel, of course they've got an existing home, existing kitchen, it might be a bathroom, whatever, it doesn't matter. We'll come out and take a look at their project. We'll do the measuring for them, come back in. While I'm at the home, I'll get the ideas that they want to incorporate into the kitchen, into the bathroom. We'll come back, we'll draw it up for them, have them come in for a meeting and go over everything with them. And once the drawings and stuff are approved, then we'll start the pricing process. We'll find out what kind of wood they want to use, what kind of countertops. Do they want corian? Do they want granite? Do they want laminate countertops?
Kingsport Cabinetry, quotes are free. Call today, 247-6134, 247-6134.
At FCA, we're touching millions one heart at a time. Since 1954, the Fellowship of Christian Athletes has been putting the heart and soul in sports by challenging athletes and coaches to impact the world for Jesus Christ. As the largest sports ministry in the world, FCA now reaches over 2 million people annually on the professional, college, high school, junior high, and youth levels. Through this shared passion for athletics and faith, lives are changed one heart at a time. Learn more at FCA.org.
American Import and Auto Repair in Johnson City takes care of both male and female customers, but owner Kim Smith says they have a special care and concern for ladies.
Being a female in what's considered a man's business, I understand the trepidation that women may have when they come to the shop. They feel like they don't know about cars, they might be intimidated, but that's not the way we do business. Everybody's treated the same. We take the time to explain anything that they have questions about, the repair, the process, the part. We want to make sure people are comfortable with what we're going to do to their vehicle and that they understand. We do cater to women in a sense. We have a real nice waiting room with nice Keurig coffee and flavored creamers, air conditioned, cushioned seats, TV, everything a girl could want while she waits for her car to be fixed.
American Import and Auto Repair in Johnson City, open 6 days a week. Call today at 913-3111.
Back on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Thanks for being with us again on this Thursday. Again, we've hit the 1 o'clock hour, so here we go, our final hour of the show. We do this each and every weekday. Again, that'll be from 11 to 2. We appreciate you being with us so very, very much again here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Baseball up and running now in the first inning. Oakland and Toronto are scoreless in their game. Also, actually, top of the second is now. They've updated. It's still scoreless between the A's and the Toronto Blue Jays. Bottom of the third, the Mets and Colorado are tied at 3 apiece. Also, starting here in just a few minutes, Texas and Minnesota, Milwaukee and Chicago a little bit later on this afternoon. So, two in progress right now. Scoreless, the A's and Toronto, and that's in the top of the second. And the bottom of the third, the Mets and Colorado in a 3-3 deadlock. And so, some offense already for both of those teams. And so they are, again, playing those two afternoon affairs. Later on, Texas and Minnesota and Milwaukee and the Cubbies at Wrigley a little bit later on this afternoon. So that's what's going on there. All right, here we go. Let's call my man Carmichael, see what he's got going on today. And let's see. We hit those, and we hit those numbers right there. And let's see what he's got, what he allows for us again on this Thursday. One ringy-dingy. There's Mr. Carmichael. He is just like the Pony Express. You can count on him every day.
Well, I was sitting by the phone and watching you on the air. So.
Oh, bless your heart. So, what do you think? You like that backdrop? Does it look a little better?
It looks a little better. And you and your dapper, as we call the family version of the I-Man. So.
The family version of Imus, is that what you're saying?
Yes, the family version of Imus.
All right. Yeah, I got called that the other day. I got called, who was the other guy? He told me. What was the guy's name that played on Lonesome Dove?
Tommy Lee Jones.
Tommy Lee Jones. Got called,
yeah,
Tommy Lee Jones.
That, especially at the end when he was taking Gus back to his burial place.
Yep, that's exactly right. That's a great series, by the way. Love Lonesome Dove.
That is the last. I mean, they can talk about, and there have been some great TV shows the last probably 10, 15 years. I mean, you've had, you know, Breaking Bad, you've had Mad Men, The Sopranos, different shows like that. But really, what I call the last big event on TV is Lonesome Dove. And if you've never watched it, you've got to sit down and watch the 8 hours of it. It's just fabulous television or fabulous movie. It'd make a great even you know, a great all day if you just were snowed in on one day to watch and you didn't have really anything in the house. That would be a great thing just to watch all day, binge watch all day long.
Now, do you like, see, I like Return of Lonesome Dove. You like John Voight in his role? Do you still like Tommy Lee Jones?
Oh, Tommy Lee, that, classic. Those, and it's a shame, neither guy won the Emmy that year. They lost the Emmy that year to, he was playing my name is Bill W. Playing he, and I drew a blank. He it was the role of the gentleman who started Alcoholics Anonymous, and they both lost that role. And the only thing I can think is they split the vote, and I can't remember. I want to say it's not William Defoe, but it was an actor like that that won the Emmy that year. But it was for he won it for the role of playing the founder of Alcoholics Anonymous.
We're talking to buddy David Carmichael. Again, he's with us, joins us with the John City Parks and Rec. So got a couple of sports stories to ask you about. What's your take on all this stuff going on in New York, the Jets and Geno and the linebacker? Now the Bills went and picked this guy up after they dropped him in New York. So Jets trying to find a quarterback. They play, I think they play tonight, as a matter of fact. So what do you do?
Ryan,
if you,
Fitzpatrick, it looks like, I guess, yeah, will be at the present will be the starting quarterback. I mean, you know what? It tells you, it shows a lack, I think, I mean, character about Geno Smith. I mean, if you owe somebody money, pay the man. I mean, mm-hmm. not just a punt. It's, you're the leader of the team. As a quarterback, you're the leader of the team. You can't be stiffing or short-arming some guy $600 when you're
making
a
big
high-priced player and he's a guy just hanging on to the team.
Giving him $600 like me giving you a $10 bill or a $5
right.
bill. This guy's loaded. And now, in defense of this linebacker, here's what happened. I think you've seen the story. He had a camp in Texas. He invites Geno Smith to come. He said, well, part of the deal, you got to pay him a plane ticket. Okay. Happened on July the 11th. So Geno bails out, can't make it for personal reasons. Okay. Well, what's right in this deal, if, you know, if you paid my ticket and I couldn't make it, the right thing me to do is go, hey, sorry I couldn't make it, but here's your $600 back. But Geno,
right.
Geno didn't want to pay him. So the guy finally confronted him. This was not the first time they've had words about this bill. And so finally he'd had enough. He was hauled back, and I guess Geno smarted off to him. He lit him up. And so, so number one, $600 is nothing. Number two, the right thing to do is reimburse the man who paid your plane ticket and you didn't show up for his camp for personal reasons. That's okay. But he did pay you $600 for your ticket. So the right thing to do is reimburse him for the ticket, which he didn't. And that's what got all this going. So the linebacker, I think, is kind of taking a bad rap because –
Yes, he is. Geno Smith should be, he should be a leader. I mean, you're the quarterback of a franchise that's one of the most visible franchises, or any. It wouldn't matter if it was, it wouldn't matter if it was the Jacksonville Jaguars. You're, you know, you're should own up to what you do.
I agree with
you. And then to taunt the guy, basically saying, like, I'm not going to pay you. Well, guess what? Well, I may not get my $600 cash, but I'm getting $600 worth of satisfaction.
There you go. It's hammer time. So, and so Ryan goes and gets his guy. Does he get him as a dig of the Jets, or does he get him because he coached him when he was with the Jets? So did he get him for his talent, because a little dig at the Jets, or both?
Probably a little of both, but yeah. I mean, evidently the guy may be a stand-up guy, and that's maybe what he's wanting to change the culture in Buffalo. They need a cultural change in Buffalo. That's been a team that's lacked for the last. I mean, they've had all these milquetoast coaches for the last few years, and there needs to be a change in culture. The new ownership in Buffalo, the same family that owns that bought the Sabres couple of years ago, the NHL team, and that guy's got a boatload of money, and he wants to win big.
There you go. We're talking to David Carmichael, our buddy, who always has a plethora of information. All right, a little closer to home, Tennessee's offensive guard out. Is he gone for the year? Is he gone temporarily? What are you hearing?
I heard temporary. Just a little while ago on Twitter, I saw it was temporary.
Okay.
It would be just an injury. They don't know any, I mean, the length. But that was before, probably about 30 minutes ago, the last time I saw. Didn't think it was as severe as it looked.
Good, because Butch Jones doesn't need that. He's trying to build himself something down there. He doesn't need this guy being out. I didn't realize they gave up 43 sacks last year, the Tennessee Vols, their offensive line. That's pretty leaky, to say the least, in a 13-game season. What is that? Almost
what was it?
Three a game?
In Dickey's time down there, they didn't recruit or sign an offensive lineman. I mean, basically when Butch Jones came in, the cupboard was literally bare.
Yes. So, and he's building up, but he can ill afford to use his most most experienced offensive lineman. And so you're telling me it's temporary. It's not a season-ending injury. Is that correct?
That is what I saw about a half hour ago. They said it was not as severe as it looked, but, you know, sometimes that, I guess, until they get him in and take a look at it and just see what they can do. You know, they probably see what after the swelling goes down, what will happen.
So I made fun of NFL preseason football back the first of the week, saying, of course, Roethlisberger and all those guys played the big boys, Minnesota and Pittsburgh.
And you shouldn't do that, because that's going to be your quiz tomorrow's NFL preseason training camp.
Well, there you go. Plus the fact, now the Jets, you got to use this thing totally. They're not just tweaking now. They're trying to find a quarterback to get this system in place. And now the preseason games beginning tonight at Detroit for Fitzpatrick and the Jets, these are very important games to get him ready with the loss of Geno Smith. So now, at least from my opinion, the preseason games of the New York Jets mean a whole lot to him now. What do you think?
Well, and it does, because and the Roethlisberger thing is one thing. They've got five games that were the Hall of Fame teams have the extra game.
Mm-hmm.
So they're going to take – nobody plays game – or not, I was going to say not anybody. Everybody but the Patriots usually don't play the starters in game four. Occasionally the Patriots will – most of the time the Patriots will play their starters in game four. But most everybody goes games one through three. And tonight usually is like a quarter – to maybe a drive into the second quarter with your starters. And I still think that will be the way with the Jets tonight. I think they'll still stay to form and stay to plan with that, because then you go next week, then you play a half, and then usually game three is the dress rehearsal, and that's when most of the teams will play up to three quarters with their starters. So that one is, I still think, because they kind of know what they've got with Fitzpatrick. He's a veteran. So I think that will, but they still like to see him work with his team. I mean, that you bring in a new receiver in Brandon Marshall and the new quarterback in Fitzpatrick, and see what they've got in this game tonight.
Yep, so it is kind of an experimental thing, no question. Again, we're talking to our buddy David Carmichael again from the John City Parks and Rec. Let's see.
Liverpool Reds got a victory on Sunday.
So what if I'm a Liverpool Red fan? What do I scream tally ho? What do they win? What do they do?
You sing you'll never walk alone.
That's you'll
your
never.
Song. That is your song. You'll never walk alone.
I don't even know the words. You have to give me the words. You have to send them to me.
It's the old standard from written during the war. You'll never walk alone. They had lost to Stoke in Captain Steven Gerrard's last match. Bad 6-1, and then they come back out and beat Stoke. I mean, Liverpool's in a kind of a rebuilding mode. They lost their captain, Steven Gerrard, played for them, English captain also. He played for them for many years. They had a young star last year, Raheem Sterling, and Sterling, during the transfer window, left and went to Manchester City. So this is kind of a rebuilding year for Brandon Rodgers. But they've got Bournemouth. That's a new team to the Premier League. They will play them in the match on Monday afternoon, the NBC Sports Network match on Monday.
I'm all tither. I'm excited about this. So I'm supposed to sing "You'll Never Walk Alone." There
you
go.
You'll never walk alone. You know, that's it's just an inspiring song. I can't remember I remember singing it when I was a kid in elementary school in a class production. And that's the Liverpool fight song.
There you go. The Liverpool Reds fight song, which I'm a proud fan. I have no clue about them. You'll never walk alone. They got a big win. We're talking to Carmichael again for the John City Parks and Rec. The Silver Sneakers. What's this all about with the Parks and Rec?
Silver Sneakers is a program. It's a circuit. It's an exercise program. Our old friend Debbie, or not really old friend, and that longtime friend, Debbie Fogle. Debbie is our program coordinator over at Senior Services now, and they're having a class that will help increase endurance and improve strength for ages 50 and older. And it's a low impact class. You know, you're not really doing a lot of hard maneuvers and everything. You do handheld weights, elastic tubing, and a silver sneaker ball to increase upper body strength.
Hmm.
And it's just something to help, especially when, as you get older, your bones, you know, start to get a little bit softer and everything. This is not an intense, really super intense class to take. And you just, you work with that, work with the weights. It helps the endurance, improves the strength. And that class is going to start on September 1st over at the Memorial Park Community Center. It'll be on Tuesdays from 8:30 to 9:30 and Fridays from 10 to 11. And if it's $3 per session, but it's free if you're a Silver Sneaker eligible participant. And you can check with the Senior Service Center over at Memorial Park to find out about that. Telephone number, if you're interested in the class, is 434-6237.
434-6237. Hey, when's Freedom Hall Pool going to open back up? Have they made an announcement on that?
I have not heard an announcement on that this week. We have just been trying to get soccer, or I have just been trying to get soccer going, and the great thing about living in this area is, it can rain over at Civitan, if you're familiar with Johnson City. It can rain over at Civitan Park, which is right off Oakland. Pour down rain there, and we're not able to play soccer. And out here at Winger Park on the Bristol Highway, the sun's out, and it's games on.
Scattered showers. Yeah, you better believe it.
They're scattered. These were not just showers Monday night. It was
monsoon.
Rain sideways.
You got it.
Because I was leaving the park right as the rain started, and it was coming down sideways.
Before I let you go, tell me also another program going on in the Parks and Rec. You'll be back with us tomorrow on the quiz show. Catch the Wave. What's this all about?
Yeah, kind of like Brian Wilson, the Beach Boys, Catch a Wave.
And you're sitting on top of the world.
Catch the Wave, Circuit More. It's a group circuit. It's a little bit more intense. Like if you're Hulk Hogan, you're going to hang and bang in with the thing. But this is a little bit more intense. Class, somebody's been exercising. The other class is more somebody, if you've not really been exercising, want to start out with something. This is a little bit more advanced. It's interval and cardiovascular program. You use the bands, the handheld weights, and body weights and core activities. So this is one, if you've been working out a while and want to pick up the exercise and just a little bit, this would be your class. It's $2 per class, and you don't need to register. Just when you show up day of the class, it's on Fridays from 8:30 to 9:30.
That's our buddy Carmichael giving the John City Parks and Rec. The website is?
www.myjcparks.com.
All right, we'll talk more tomorrow about Lonesome Dove, and if you can see the Freedom Hall pool is going to be open between now and tomorrow, I'm all about it. I love swimming in that pool.
Yes, sir, I will find that out for you.
Yeah, I went over the other night, and you're right, it was closed. I was ready to get in and do a can opener off the diving board, and no go, but maybe
it's like Jimmy Superfly Snook off the top of the cage at Madison Square Garden.
Yeah, in a roundabout way, I guess. Yeah.
Yeah.
Carmichael, you're the best. I'll talk to you tomorrow, right?
We'll see you tomorrow.
Yes, sir. Good man right there. David Carmichael again from the Johnson City Parks and Rec here again on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Let's go right back to the phone. We got a couple more folks to get on the board before we run out of time here. We'll go and get our buddy David Crum from the Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency, see what's going on in the woods and waterways of Tennessee here on this Thursday. And let's see, that's one ringy-dingy.
Good afternoon, Tom Taylor. How are you in the sports show doing today?
We're doing fantastic. Our buddy is with us live on the air, our buddy David Crum, the Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency officer, ready to go. And let's jump in and go. The new hunting guides are out. Tell us about that with the TWRA.
Tennessee have been available online for about a week, and the new hunting guides came into the regional office and are being distributed now as we speak by different officers out to the license agents. There are a lot of different changes to the hunting regulations this year. Matter of fact, early on in the hunting guide, on page 8, I'm looking at one now, there's a listing of several important changes that are made to the hunting and trapping regulations for 2015 and 16. And among those, a lot of folks have been really pushing for it really hard, is to get a 2-buck limit, that's a 2-antler deer limit for the whole season, archery muzzleloader and gun combined. Only 2-antler deer are allowed for the state of Tennessee. The thought process behind this is to hopefully allow some of the younger deer to get more mature. Tennessee does have some good quality deer. It's not like the genetics that are available in the northern states where deer are growing up to 300 pounds, but we do have a lot of good genetics, especially for the south. By letting some of the younger bucks go through, you'll end up having a higher quality of deer and better deer management going on throughout the state. There's several different changes listed, such as to the early wood duck and teal season, exemption for taking the hunter education field day as discussed. A guide license is now required for anyone who takes compensation for guiding a hunt. There's also several different things mentioned about some new wildlife management areas, new hunting opportunities down Lit Creek Bottoms there at the wetland area in Greene County. And also, you know, there's some new, for the one of the big wildlife management areas, North Cumberland Wildlife Management Area, there's some adjustments there also. All of these changes can be found either online of tnwildlife.org, that's tnwildlife.org, or you can go to your local license agent anywhere throughout the state of Tennessee and pick up one of the hunting guides. We'll go by one of the regional offices.
We're talking to our buddy David Crum, the Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency officer. What is the first season coming up? Is it rabbit or squirrel? What's first up chronologically this fall?
Squirrel season's right around the end of the right around the corner, Tom. Squirrel season opens up at the end of the month, where you can take little folks out, or even older little folks out. You know, kids of all ages get to go out and enjoy squirrel season opening up. I think most of us, you know, people say squirrels go out and cut nuts. You can hear them crunching the nuts out there while they're in the trees, and that's one of the ways that you can actually locate the squirrels. Most of us actually started all of our hunting regular squirrel hunting, and that's how it opened up. That fall squirrel season opens up August 22nd, so that's just within a matter of a few days.
We're talking to David Crum, the Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency officer. Here's a breaking story. There was an injury. Tennessee receiver Marquez North could miss the entire season after suffering an injury in practice. Apparently, it's not going to be as bad as they thought. He got hurt this morning in practice at Tennessee football. Tennessee receiver Marquez North could miss the entire season after suffering an injury in practice, but apparently, according to another report, the injury only keep him out of practice about a week, maybe even less than that, which is very good news. So North got hurt in practice today, but apparently it is not going to be a season-ending injury for the Tennessee football team, which obviously is a very good thing. The Gray Fair, my friend, comes up week after next, getting ready for the Appalachian Fair. You'll have your big display in the middle of the fairgrounds. Tell me about that, would you please?
Tom, our fair display is probably one of the most visited booths in the whole Appalachian Gray Fair. We've got a simulated stream moving around. We've got simulated cold water reservoir, warm water reservoir, cold water streams. We've got trout, bass, about any kind of fish you would want to imagine to be able to take a look at, including the large attraction, which is the 5,000-gallon turtle tank. This turtle tank, you can actually crawl through a big tunnel and look up, just like at some of these big aquariums, and look up through the viewfinders and see the fish and the turtles swimming across in front of you. We've got a lot of good wildlife there. We've got a wetlands exhibit. We've got a farmland exhibit. A lot of good diversity in the habitat represented there. And we'll also have some TWRA personnel on hand throughout the week to answer questions while the booth is open. So if you get a chance to go to the Appalachian Gray Fair, stop by and check us out. You might find out some information that you didn't know about before. Nothing else, you'll be able to get close to some wild critters that you will never be able to get this close to ever again.
There you go. We'll save the Boone Lake Habitat Management. Kind of running short on time here. We'll get that back in here next week. But again, Appalachian Fair and also the new hunting guides are out. Website for the TWRA. Tell me about that, would you please?
The website is tnwildlife.org. That's tnwildlife.org. A lot of good information on the website. Feel free to go there. If you have any questions, contact the regional office.
Your boys play in Jacksonville this weekend. Is it tomorrow night or is it Saturday? It is tomorrow night.
It's tomorrow night.
Yep, 7:30 kickoff.
Tomorrow night.
No, it's tomorrow night. 7:30 kickoff in Jacksonville. So,
When is it?
Tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night. I was thinking it was tonight for some reason. Okay, I was getting a little excited. As I tell you, you mentioned something earlier about a UT player getting injured. Have you seen the beef that UT has on the front line this year?
Yeah.
Some of those freshmen.
There's some meat on the hoof.
Those are some big boys.
You got that right. There's some meat on the hoof at Tennessee. You're right. That program's coming. give, I don't know about this year, but next year and going forward, they ought to be loaded for bear. But and maybe this year, but
when they get some seasoning under their belt and get some of those freshmen trained like they want them, like Coach Jones wants them trained, holy cow, UT's going to be a team to be reckoned with again. And yet, let's go back to the Pittsburgh Steelers that are going to beat Jacksonville tomorrow night. I know we lost in the exhibition game, but you know, hey, it's still preseason.
There you go. You're exactly right. Got the Jags tomorrow night in Florida. Mr. Crum, as always, you are awesome. We appreciate this great free information every week here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Leave us with that famous hook, would you please?
Remember, folks, get your kids hooked on hunting and fishing, and you don't have to worry as much about them getting hooked on other things. And safe boating saves lives.
Great job, my friend. Keep on keeping on. Stay cool. It's going to be another muggy weekend out there in the woods and waterways of Tennessee. A little feel of fall here coming up. Real quick, let me ask you this question before I let you go. You always kind of give me a report on the upcoming winter. What is things looking like out of the woods here so far? Is there a heavy nut crop, and is there signs we're going to have a rough winter?
I have seen apple trees out that are loaded down. I've seen some beech trees out that are loaded down heavier than I have ever seen in a long time. And even some of those few and far between chestnut trees are loaded down this year. So I think the good Lord above is getting ready to take care of us for another cold winter.
I've got four real legitimate foggy August mornings so far. Of course, the old farmer's tale back up home, every foggy August morning represents a snow event. I've got four so far. What about you? Because you're out there more than I am in the woods.
I think you're about right, Tom, with four. I know the big snow event last year was on my wedding day of November 1st when we had an outdoor wedding planned. It ended up snowing 6 inches. So that was, I tell you, any time you ever want to figure out if the good Lord above has got a sense of humor, all you have to do is make a plan.
You got it. That's exactly right. And the interesting part about that is we've got four snow events already in August, and we're just on the 13th day of the month. We got another 18 days left. So it could be giving us a sign of a lot of snow coming. But, Mr. Crum, I thank you, my friend. Keep smiling, and we'll talk to you next Thursday, all right?
Thank you very much, Tom. You take care, and I'll talk to you next week.
You got it. Good man right there, buddy. David Crum, the Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency officer. Appreciate him very much here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. It is a Thursday. Again, Marquez North hurt in practice this morning. Originally thought he's going to miss the entire season. That has now been changed, which is a good thing. And the injury will only keep him out of practice maybe a week or so, which is good. 6'3 receiver, one of Tennessee's most dangerous weapons in the passing game. Again, caught 30 passes, 320 yards, and four touchdowns last year. And so Marquez North hurt this morning in practice. Thought it was going to be season-ending, but it's not, and that is a good thing. So we'll see how he bounces back and should be back out of the injury on the injury list in a week to 10 days and ready to go to continue to practice for the Tennessee Volunteers of Butch Jones. Tom Taylor Sports Show, thanks for being with us here again on this Thursday afternoon. We told you last week, there's a story about James Harden. Remember James? James was wooed with a $200 million contract to leave Nike and to sign with Adidas to have a tennis shoe designed after him and so on and so forth. Well, guess what? Now, if you thought he wasn't going to do it, I don't know what you were thinking. Who would not do this? Well, actually, it took about 10 days to decide, so I guess he did really have to sit down and think. But Nike has declined to match the 13-year, $200 million deal Adidas has offered James Harden. And so that Adidas deal kicks in October the 1st. He went for it. He's going to do it. 13 years, $200 million deal to wear the Adidas shoe. See, if I'm Adidas, what are you thinking? Because I bet you go back and look, the length of an NBA player, I don't think would be on the average 13 years. So I don't know what they're expecting this guy to be around that long, because typically the longevity of an NBA player, I don't think is 13 years. I don't have that in front of me, but I wouldn't think so. I would go 7 or 8, maybe 9, but 13, that's kind of a stretch. And yet they signed this guy up to wear Adidas shoes for 13 years for $200 million. They've also got Derrick Rose and John Wall, among others, that are now wearing the Adidas. Remember back in the day, I guess I'm going to tell my age here. Back when I was growing up, everybody wanted to wear the P-U-M-A. We called them Puma back up home. I don't know if that's really the way they pronounce it, but that and Adidas was just coming on the market. Of course, you had Nike was kind of, never heard much about Nike growing up. It was Converse was the big one. We were growing up in West Virginia. Those Chuck Taylors. So anyway, that's That's what you got. Let's go to the phone right here. Good afternoon. You're on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Who's this?
Well, this is Jim Klein.
Hello, Jim Klein, a big old tall drink of water. How you doing? Our phone thing. This is a new thing at work. That's really cool. How you doing?
It's funny how those things, technology works, isn't it? I am doing great. It's a wonderful day in the neighborhood here in Kingsport.
Yeah, I didn't say that right. We were trying something new here, and I thought, I'm going to let him call me on our new phone line. So we're going to get ready to start taking phone calls here next week on the show. And I thought, we're going to let Mr. Klein, he'd be a good guinea pig, and you came right through in flying colors. So the phone line works. And, man, I was over there a week or so ago, and, whoo, you guys have been busy. What are some of the concerns and claims? I guess some of these summer storms, you've been writing claims, is that right?
We have. You know, that's one thing about it. We want to always talk to people about how you're covering your property. You know, on your homeowners, do you have the proper coverage for wind and hail? Do you have replacement coverage for your roof? Do you have replacement coverage for your home? Roofs have become a big issue in our industry. So, you know, when have you replaced it? When have you done something? How do you want to protect it? Farmers insurance, we give a new roof discount as long as we have the documentation that it's been replaced in the last 10 years. And most people do keep that because roofs have warranties in case something goes wrong with the shingles or the metal fades or anything to that nature. So, you know, and again, just discussing, how do you want things covered if that tree does fall on your house? Because we have had some, you know, clip the corner of houses and smash the back fence or tear up the gazebo. And when all this wind and everything comes through, and same thing on the automobiles, you know, your comprehensive coverage is what takes care of that. So if a storm comes through and throws, you know, it could be the neighbor's trash can, or it could be the limb out of the tree, or it could be the pot you had on the front porch that goes flying off and damages your automobile. Do you have coverage? You know, what deductible do you have? Do you have rental car if it's going to be in the shop? You know, we just ask for an opportunity. You know, we have Tracy and Sandy and Karen and Tim and myself, and we just want the opportunity to sit down and discuss your insurance needs and customize the plan that's going to meet your needs.
One of our great sponsors of the Tom Taylor Sports Show, our buddy Jim Klein. We've been together, 15, 16, if not longer, years. He handles my auto insurance and what else you got? You got
home warranty.
Life insurance. You got all that stuff for me. So I'm all about Jim Klein Farmers Insurance. One of the things he told me a couple of years ago, one of my interviews on the morning show that I did here in the Tri-Cities was, and I never thought of this, the back of your washer, when you take off, when you get ready to go out of town on vacation, go somewhere for an extended period of time, or even if you're just going down the street to go shopping for groceries, whatever, sometimes that thing burst, and you've written claims and filed claims where those hoses have burst in the back of a washing machine and really caused a lot of damage, haven't they?
Exactly. You know, water does a lot more damage than people realize. Water can do just as much damage as fire can do to a home. So, you know, we talk to people about, you know, checking things periodically. You know, if you haven't changed those water lines, change them. They do make the braided ones, which are, you know, they're supposed to last for almost a lifetime versus the rubber ones. You know, the rubber ones, especially on that hot water side, you know, the hot, and then it gets cold when it sits there and then hots again, and so it does deteriorate that rubber over time. Same thing when you're talking about the little line underneath your commode. You know, that line that feeds to that tank, most of them are a plastic line, and you need to replace it every now and then, and or they make the aluminum braided ones for it that are supposed to last longer underneath sinks. You know, we had a gentleman, and actually, you know, it was a newer home, but, you know, things do happen. You know, he went to work, and the line underneath his bathroom sink must have blew. He said, I had to blow the minute I left, because he had forgot something, went running home during his lunch hour to get something, and water's running down his steps, you know.
Oh.
Over $30,000 worth of water damage in about a four-hour time frame.
Oh.
So it doesn't take long. So those are things we address with people. We talk to people. You know, have your gutterings been cleaned out? You want to be sure that they're cleaned out. You know, we're going to go into fall season. So as we get into fall and the leaves start coming down, you want to be sure to clean the leaves off the valleys of your house, but also you want to get it out of that guttering so when we get the rains and the snow and stuff this fall and winter, that everything will drain properly away from the home and doesn't cause damage. Because, you know, insurance is something we all have, and if we have that major loss, we want to make sure we're properly and protected. And, again, that's what we want to discuss with you, how you want to be protected. But also they can be an aggravation, so we want to guide you in what are things you can do to prevent things from happening so you don't have to deal with it?
We're talking to Jim Klein, Farmers Insurance, again, 247-5400. Again, what's the latest award? You're the number one agent in how many states?
Well, we have been blessed with the President's Council Award.
He hates this.
And that is Farmers' Top Honors. It's 0.5% of the agency force. So I was the one for the one of two out of the state of Tennessee because they do that by state. And we were blessed with that this year. We have continued to get honors for all of our hard work. And, again, it takes the whole staff here to do it. You know, Sandy's mm-hmm. my right-hand lady. She's got to guide me throughout the day always. And the other ladies are in here to take care of it all the time. So we do have a great staff. But we do get recognized for, as you said, taking care of our customers. You know, that's something, too, you know. September the 3rd, we're trying to get planned out for a customer appreciation day for people to stop by and let us, you know, tell them how much we appreciate them, have hot dogs and drinks and everything for everybody. And we do appreciate our customers, and we just want the opportunity to guide you in the right direction. And it has blessed me with many awards, and we have been blessed.
Absolutely. 247-5400. Again, last question. Folks getting ready to send kids off to college may need an extra car, may need some rental. And we talked about this once, too. For dormitories, do you have everything covered? And do you know that everything's going to be covered if there's something goes wrong in the dorm where your college student's going to be at? So that's another thing you can look at is renter's insurance to cover their content. Is that correct?
Sure can. As you just said, you know, we can extend some coverage off of parents, homeowners, if they're in a dormitory or a school-sponsored housing. But once they go to those apartments that are outside of it, they need to get that renter's coverage. And how's it going to be? Do they have the towing and emergency road service on their car? So when they're traveling to and from, if they had a flat, ran out of gas, couldn't get the car to move, and need to get some assistance, you know, you may not be able to get there if they're an hour and a half, 2 hours from home. This way, there's a toll-free number. They're going to send out certified people to help them get that car back underway or get it to a shop that can get it back underway, depending on the situation, to get on down the road. You know, it could be as little as a battery problem, but it's pretty hard when you're 2 or 3 hours away from them to help them take care of that problem. And with our roadside assistance, they'll help them 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
There you go. Jim Klein, Farmers Insurance, 247-5400. You can write insurance, obviously, in Tennessee. Where else?
Virginia. We do Tennessee and Virginia.
There you go.
Of course, Farmers is throughout the United States, but we are licensed for Tennessee and Virginia. We do quite a bit of work up in the Bristol area and quite a bit of work across the line on Gate City and Weber City and Duffield for those people coming over to our community to do business and take care of their insurance needs.
You got one old cowboy licensed. You take care of him over in Johnson City, don't you? That old Taylor fella?
I do. I know you called me a pig a minute ago. I might call you a horse.
No, I said a big old tall drink of water.
I would never, I know.
I never call you a pig. Heavenly days, you bigger than me, you stomp me. What are you talking about?
I don't know about that.
Well, if you and I ever got
it'd be interesting to see which one can swing the hardest. You know, we probably neither one get there.
No, I'm going to take one swing. I'll be tired. I'll be looking for something to drink or a cookie or something. So, hey, I appreciate you. You're awesome. Thank you very, very much. Keep on keeping on, and I'll talk to you soon, all right?
Take care. You too. Bye-bye.
Yep, good man right there. He does a great job. Our buddy Jim Klein for Jim Klein Farmers Insurance. Here's a baseball scoreboard update. Top of the fourth inning, Toronto's jumped out. They broke a scoreless affair to a 4-0 lead over Oakland. Toronto's 63-52. They're, what, 11 over? 500. A's are 13 under. Struggling right now. They're trailing 4-0 in the top of the fourth are the Oakland A's. Also in the bottom of the second, Minnesota's taking a 1-0 lead over Texas in afternoon games. Also, you have at the end of the fourth inning, Colorado and the Mets. Mets have got up on them pretty good. 6-3 going to the top of the fifth now. Mets lead it 6-3 over Colorado. And Milwaukee and Chicago will line up and go and have that first pitch coming up at 2:20 this afternoon at Wrigley Field. We, of course, will be stepping away here in a few minutes. Tonight, under the lights, you've got New York at Cleveland, Los Angeles at Kansas City in the American League. In the National League tonight, good one, Pittsburgh at St. Louis. Pittsburgh chasing the Cardinals, 5 out, so they're going to try and put some heat on them, and they can do that playing them head-to-head tonight. Liriano will go for Pittsburgh, and Lance Lynn will go for the Cardinals. Tonight, the Reds, they got Samson on the hill for Cincinnati. against Matt Latos, a former Red, in Dodger Stadium tonight at a 10:10 first pitch our time. Also tonight, Washington and San Francisco out of the left coast. It'll be Strasburg for Washington. Ryan Vogelsong will go for the San Francisco Giants. Giants 60-53, and Washington only 3 over .500 at 58-55 on the season. So again, right now, top of the fourth, Toronto 4, Oakland nothing. Bottom of the second, Minnesota leads Texas 1-0. And also in the top of the fifth, New York's doubled up Colorado right now to the tune of 6-3. And that is your Major League Baseball update as of right now. Let's see. I was going to try and see. Here we go. The PGA leaderboard. Now, see what's going on with the PGA Championship right now. And the leaderboard as they're playing in Wisconsin. It goes as follows. Your current leader is J.B. Holmes. Dustin Johnson sitting second. Jason Day currently third. Harris English. Let's see. Actually, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six tied for third right now. And that would include Jason Day, Harris English, Russell Henley, Matt Jones, Matt Kuchar, opens in it right, Danny Lee, Thomas Bjorn. Those folks are in the hunt right now. Again, on top of the leaderboard, again, 8 under through 16 would be J.B. Holmes from the United States, Dustin Johnson, second, 6 under through 16. And so they're playing as we speak, obviously, in Wisconsin with the PGA Championship, and the winner will bring home a cool $1.8 million for their efforts again for the weekend of the PGA Championship. Not too bad, to say the least. What else happening in sports? We were talking about this story, again, with James Harden. Harden, again, officially signing $200 million deal with the Adidas shoe company, leaving Nike as of October the 1st. 13-year deal, $200 million. Going to have his own shoe. He's going to have a lot of things, have a lot of input into the designing of a shoe with his logo. And, of course, he's the man with the beard, and I'm sure part of his logo will be with the big, thick beard that he wears, and that's kind of his statement, his signature, if you will, of the young man who plays for the Houston Rockets. So James Harden, again, $200 million richer, and a 13-year contract to peddle Adidas shoes. So there you go. What else happening in sports? If you're a Cleveland Browns fan, here's the very latest in the Brownies. Again, the coach reaffirming his commitment to McCown. Not good news for Johnny Manziel, but Josh McCown is firmly the number one quarterback. That is the very latest from the Cleveland camp. And so, again, the Browns play when? Tomorrow night or tonight? They will play tonight against the Washington Redskins in exhibition football. Johnny Manziel and Brian Hoyer are not in the fray right now. McCown is been told, as the coach says, McCown is his man right now. During his 12-year career, McCown has completed, 978 passes, 61 touchdowns, 59 interceptions. That's not a good rate. 61 touchdowns and 59 picks. That is not a good ratio by any stretch of the imagination. And so he is the man, and I don't know if I want to be able to ride my glory train with a guy who's been in 12 years and thrown 61 TDs but thrown 59 interceptions. That's not a real good batting average, obviously. So we'll see if he can continue to be the man. But Brian Hoyer and Johnny Manziel and also Connor Shaw trying to put some heat on him. But McCown is the man. I'm assuming he'll start tonight for a couple of series or whatever the number of reps he'll take as the starting quarterback tonight when the Browns host the Washington Redskins and NFL preseason football. We'll come right back with our final break, and we'll come back and tell you just exactly who is playing where tonight in the NFL preseason football. The real team, as we told you, plays tomorrow night. That would be
the Raiders.
They'll be taking on the St. Louis Rams tomorrow night. Got a lunch bet on this one. Rob Cole from Bays Mountain Park is a huge Rams fan. I'm sorry for that, at least for this week, because he's playing my team. So I got a lunch bet, Clark's Grocery there in Sullivan Gardens, that the Raiders will beat the Rams tomorrow night in exhibition football. And so I hope so, or otherwise I'm going to have to pony up and pay him another meal like I normally do when we make these bets. I very seldom win food bets with my man Rob Cole. Quick break. We'll be right back. We'll run down the NFL preseason schedule for you tonight right here and talk some Appalachian League Baseball right after this on the Tom Taylor Sports Show.
At American Import and Auto Repair in Johnson City, one of the eight areas of your vehicle that takes constant continuing education is the air conditioner on your vehicle.
Well, you would think that AC would be a simple one, but it's getting to be a lot bigger than just AC. It's the management of the system, not just AC, but heat and everything. It's a lot more computer controlled than it used to be. It used to be just a little button on the dash that you pushed. Now there's all kinds of electronics involved in that. Braking systems used to be fairly simple. Now some of the newer vehicles, you have to have a computer to actually operate the braking system to make sure that it's okay after you've worked on it. Computer controlled of the engine is becoming very important. There's a lot to that. Each one of these areas, the technology has just tripled and quadrupled in the last few years. It's hard to keep up. You really need to stay in the books and know what's going on with them.
American Import Auto Repair, Johnson City, open 6 days a week. Call today at 913-3111.
It's Friday night at 7 o'clock. You've been involved in a car accident. You may be out of state on vacation or just a few miles from home. What do? Who do you call? At Farmers Insurance Group, one call is all you have to make. Hello, this is Jim Klein, an agent with Farmers Insurance. It's called One and Done. You don't have to wait till Monday morning to file a claim. You can make the initial call, and we begin right away to help you. We assist you in moving the vehicle to a certified repair shop, getting you set up with rental car, and informing your agent. Then here at the staff at Jim Klein Farmers Insurance, we follow the claim through to the end. It's that easy. One and done. We're your one and done location for all your insurance needs. Auto, home, life, commercial, workers' comp, and bonds. We can help you with all your insurance needs. Give me a call today, Jim Klein, Jim Klein Farmers Insurance at 247-5400. Your one and done location in Kingsport, 247-5400.
Kingsport Cabinetry installs cabinets and countertops all over the three-state region. Owner Richard Isaac says there is no charge for his quotes.
All of our quotes and drawings are free. I know a lot of the national chains, big box stores and stuff, and I understand they have to charge a price to come out and measure and do a quote, but here at Kingsport Cabinetry, we do all that for free in hopes that our service is good enough. I always tell people this, Tom. I say, you can go anywhere in this town and get a product like I have, but find somebody you're comfortable working with. If you're not comfortable working with me, find somebody you are comfortable working with. But I can guarantee you we'll give you the service. We have a full shop back here that we do custom work, and I'll just move on a little bit. We get into commercial work. We do a lot of commercial work, a lot of healthcare, a lot of restaurants, banks, schools, things like that too.
Kingsport Cabinetry. Call Richard Isaacs today at 247-6134.
Back on the Tom Miller Sports Show, a little breaking story here that's not sports-related, but I'm watching this very intently throughout the last couple of weeks, how this unfolds. But there apparently within the Hillary Clinton camp, some folks in her inner circle who illegally stripped the classification markings from her personal emails after it was revealed that top-secret information was being traversed from a private server when she was Secretary of State. Interesting. Inner Circle illegally stripped the classification markings from her personal emails after it was revealed that top secret information traversed her private server while she was Secretary of State. Then you got a story. Did you see this? And this has nothing to do with sports, but it got me jacked up. I can tell you that. Got a writer who claims the American flag is racist. You know, I was got on Rush Limbaugh's website here a couple of weeks ago. I get on a lot of people's website. He said, it'll come a day, then somebody will come out and say the American flag is racist. And here it is. In fact, there's a former POW who was held, obviously, as a prisoner of war, who came back here to the United States, who claims, I mean, he just went off to I'll have to go and check and see who this writer is, but somebody said the American flag is racist. So anyway, this former POW is sounding off, and of course, you can't see the flag. I got to change it. I've got one up here on the wall, but I got to rearrange it a little bit here and make it more pronounced where you can see it. You can see it yesterday. It's right above the Tom and Tom Taylor. But anyway, holy tamale. That's all I'm going to say. Goodness gracious. Lousy mercy. All right, let's see. NFL preseason football tonight. New Orleans and Baltimore. The American flag is racist? Good grief. New Orleans and Baltimore tonight. Also Green Bay and New England. New York Jets looking for a quarterback. They'll start out with Fitzpatrick and try to work some other guys in. They'll be in Detroit tonight to battle the Lions. Miami at Chicago to battle the Bears. Cleveland home tonight to the Washington Redskins. And Dallas will be at San Diego. All this going on again in NFL preseason football tonight. Again, around the National Football League. Tomorrow night, Carolina Buffalo, the Titans, will play their first game on the road in Atlanta against the Falcons. Also tomorrow night, the Steelers in Jacksonville, Giants at Cincinnati, Denver at Seattle, and St. Louis at you-know-where, the Raiders. Tomorrow night at 10 o'clock. Saturday, Tampa Bay, Minnesota. The 49ers played Houston, Kansas City at Arizona. All those on Saturday, and the last game in the NFL preseason for this weekend will be on Sunday afternoon, Indianapolis at Philadelphia. Appalachian League Baseball, it's who's playing where tonight. You can watch them in the Tri-Cities in Johnson City at Cardinal Park. They'll be hosting Kingsport in Bristol tonight. The Pirates hosting the Elizabethan Twins. Also tonight in the Appy League, Greenville at Pulaski, Danville at Burlington, and Princeton playing against their cross-county rival in West Virginia, in Southern West Virginia, the Bluefield Blue Jays. Standings in the East, Princeton and Pulaski are a dead even, 28 and 21. They're tied for the lead in the East. In the West, it's tightened up. Greenville now only with a one-game lead over Kingsport. Elizabeth and a game and a half back. Bristol, 2.5 back. And Johnson City's had a tailspin. They're in the cellar right now, but still they're only 4 games back at 25, or rather 21 and 25. So certainly doable for them to come back and make a run for it. 4 games out in the cellar of the Western Division, the Appalachian League, is not insurmountable, to say the least. And so tonight you have action, as we said. Twins will be in Bristol. Also in the Tri-Cities, the Johnson City Cardinals hosting Kingsport. Also tonight, Greenville on the road at Pulaski, Danville at Burlington, and Bluefield hosting Princeton in the Appalachian League. It's the Tom Taylor Sports Show, beginning to wind this thing down. New hours, 11 to 2 every day, Monday through Friday. We will park it on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday of next week, as we'll shift gears and bring you some outstanding coverage. A lot of folks at Bristol Motor Speedway and Bristol Live. And, oh, yeah, thank you. And so we will be back in action again on Monday and Tuesday here in studio, and tomorrow as well. The next Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, we'll be back at it. Thanks, Gator. We'll be back at it Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. We'll park it and be at Bristol Live at Bristol Motor Speedway. But again, tomorrow in studio, Monday and Tuesday, then we'll park the whole show for the remainder of next week and rejoin you a week from Monday. But tomorrow, right back out here, 11 to 2. We'll see what happens tonight if NFL preseason football. Be interesting to see how the Jets attack this dilemma they're in and how they can, you know, try out Ryan Fitzpatrick. Again, we told you yesterday they went after Michael Vick. He wasn't interested. Said thanks, but no thanks. So, for whatever reason, he had other things to do, and he didn't want to try and make a comeback in the National Football League with the New York Jets. So, they're going to be trying out some different QBs tonight. It'll be interesting to see how that experiment works for the New York Jets as they get ready for the Detroit Lions tonight in the Silverdome in Detroit. We are your home for the Science Hill Hilltopper sports season coming up. Very excited about that. We've been embraced by the community, and that's an understatement. And very, very excited about bringing you Science Hill Hilltopper football coming up 2 weeks. Seems like we keep talking about this and talking about this. Like it's never going to get here. Then you're going to look up. It'll be like game four of the season. Once it gets going, you just fly through the weeks. And so Science Hill with no open date. Their only open date is this, or is the 21st, because they will have 10 straight Friday nights beginning on the 28th with the Elizabethan Cyclone. So we're looking forward to being very much a part of the Science Hill Hilltopper sports family. We were there last Saturday for Media Day, and so we will be interviewing different coaches throughout the season, whether it's Coach Brockett with the cross country or Coach Van Hoy with golf, and we're going to be talking to the Science Hill coaching staff a lot, and so we're very excited about that, particularly heading into September and the rest of August. Of course, next week, as we said, the focal point of really what's going on next week will be, for us, Bristol Motor Speedway. We did tell you yesterday, we looked out the windows we left, and yep, the campers are coming in here. Earhart Campground, I mean, these folks are already starting to camp, and this thing's, what, 9 days away, the cup race. Of course, we're inside of a week now, 6 days away from the doubleheader next Wednesday night. Point being, folks are coming in here. Now, when they come to the grocery store, and they come to the gas pumps, they come here, come there, and spend that money. That's money we didn't have for our tax coffers, so be nice to them. They're already starting to come, and that is a really good sign of what's about to happen next week with the traffic and the fan base and everybody coming to the world's last great Coliseum. That's very, very exciting. Before we get out of here, again, the baseball scoreboard update. Middle of the fifth inning, Toronto leads Oakland 4-0. In the end of the fifth inning, the Mets lead Colorado 7-3. Top of the third, Minnesota's increased their lead 4-0 now over the Texas Rangers. and the Cubbies getting ready to do battle here in about 20 minutes. The other afternoon affair, Chicago in Wrigley with John Lester on the mound, who's not had a good season. He's only 7-8. This is the guy they went after in the offseason and paid through the nose to get this guy. He's 7-8 on the season with an ERA of 3.22. John Lester will take on Tyler Cravey, C-A-R-V-Y, and that'll be the opponent for the Milwaukee Brewers. 2:20 first pitch again at Wrigley Field in Chicago. Tonight under the lights, you've got the Yankees in Cleveland. You have L.A. in Kansas City to battle the Royals. In the National League, you've got a good one brewing. You've got Pittsburgh at St. Louis. Pirates with Francisco Liriano on the mound against Lance Lynn for the Cardinals. And then Cincinnati will take on the Dodgers. Out on the left coast, Sampson will be on the hill for Cincinnati. And Latos, former Red, on the hill for the Dodgers. Also on the left coast tonight, Washington, Steven Strasburg will take on Ryan Vogelsong and the San Francisco Giants in San Francisco. We are out of time. We sincerely thank you for yours. We'll be back at it tomorrow. It's almost 1 o'clock. At 11 o'clock, new start time. Still getting used to it. Love it, though. And by virtue of the response we're getting, we thank you. You like it, too. You can listen to us over the lunch hour. And so we'll be back ready with a brand-new set of guests tomorrow. We want to say thanks to our guest today. That would be Daniel Manjay, the sports information director from Milligan College. They just picked up a former big leaguer. It's going to be on the pitching staff of the Milligan College baseball team. Tim Smith, one of our great sponsors from American Import and Auto Repair. David Carmichael, need I say more, from the Johnson City Parks and Rec. That guy's a plethora of information. Also, Jim Klein from Jim Klein Farmers Insurance. And also, we want to say thanks to David Crum, the Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency officer, checking in with us, talking about the new hunting guide, getting ready for the display you'll see in a couple of weeks at the Appalachian Fair, and also getting you ready for just hunting and fishing here in the late summer and fall right around the corner here in the woods and waterways of the great state of Tennessee. Again, out of time, we sincerely thank you for yours. Back at it. Just wrapping up day number 126 here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Love it, love it, love it. Picked up a brand new sponsor. We are excited to tell you that Blue Lizard Australian Sunscreen coming on starting the first of the week, which is very good. We love it. Love me some Blue Lizard. Out of time, we sincerely thank you for yours. Win or lose, be a good sport. Thanks for giving us a look and a listen. We're going to be on iTunes, TuneIn Radio, YouTube, Stitcher phone app tonight. Check us out then, and we'll see you tomorrow at 11 o'clock. So long, everybody.